This time to please rise, remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem conducted by Director of Bands, Dr. Kristen Zelnick.
All right, we'll try that and see if that works. So we are here live at Conway Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. Maybe you can check it here first before you go back upstairs. All right. And I'm Jimmy Sledge. Alongside going to be Mr. Sam Johnson. Sam, welcome to the broadcast.
Thank you very much, sir. Yes. Good to be here.
We are here, and the Weevils, of course, coming off a win last week over Northwest Oklahoma State, and Southwest coming off a loss to Ouachita Baptist out there in Weatherford, Oklahoma. If you look at the conference standings, Harding, Ouachita, UAM, Southern Arkansas, and Henderson State, along with Oklahoma Baptist. They all won last week. The teams that lost were Southeastern Oklahoma State, East Central, Arkansas Tech, Southern Nazarene, Southwestern Oklahoma State, and Northwestern Oklahoma State. They were all on the losing end. So you had all the Arkansas teams except Arkansas Tech in the win column last week. Well, Sam, you look at today's ball game, and I know you're like me. We hadn't had a whole lot of chance to do a lot of pre-game work, but this ought to be a good ball game.
Yes, sir. I think it will be. We talked before we got on the air about the offensive coordinator, Josh Qualls. He's probably going to try to run and gun that thing everywhere, so probably should be an exciting game.
You know, last week we saw Demayan Brown. He's the leader on this team. He's the quarterback, and he had 388 yards, I think, on the air. And they ended up with 500 total yards on the day. He scored 49 points and get the win on the road. In our interview with Coach Jackson this afternoon, I talked to him, and he said, boy, he sure would like to average 500 yards a game.
That'd help out the defense quite a bit. The D coordinator probably think that was a good idea.
And then you look on the other side, it seemed like Southwest, they played a very good Ouachita Baptist team last week out in Weatherford. They couldn't get much established on the run or the pass against Ouachita.
I'll say that's a tough way to have to start with the Tigers right off the bat.
And both teams are about to get set. It's been Parent and Family Day here on the campus of UAM, so we've got a good crowd on hand to witness tonight's ball game. Glad you're with us here on the radio, and those of you streaming and watching it live, we appreciate you as well for being a part of it. We're going to take one more break, and then we'll come back with more on our pregame show when we return after this timeout.
I sound like an idiot.
And we welcome you back here to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. They're having a coin toss out at the center of the field. We'll tell you who won the toss in just a moment. Who's going to get the football, but our captains are, let's see, what we got out there, Zachary Gazzotti, along with Tyler Constanita, and Theron Bellard. We are captains for the Weevils. Like UAM won the toss and deferred to the second half as they will be kicking off, and we'll put the UAM defense out there. You know, if you can come out and shut them down first thing, that's what the defense coordinator wants to do.
Exactly. Let them have three plays, and that's it.
Yeah, we welcome you to our broadcast. I'm Jimmy Sledge alongside Mr. Sam Johnson, and we are set for our home opener here this evening as the Weevils get set to take on the Bulldogs of Southwest Oklahoma State. And again, we expect to see Demayan Brown throw the football around. He's got four or five really talented receivers, and you never know exactly which one of them's going to come up with it. But Isaiah Cross was his favorite receiver last week. He ended up with a little over 100 yards receiving and a touchdown. Actually, we had two receivers go over 100 yards receiving in last week's ball game. So we'll see how the Weevils work out here tonight. Hailing the kickoff duties for the Weevils,
Dylan Duhon.
Grassati does the extra point kicking and field goal kicking, but they let Duhon handle the kickoffs. And last week, he was kicking it down inside the 10 on almost every kickoff. Been a beautiful day across southeast Arkansas, a beautiful night for football, and we are underway. It's going to be high end-over-end kick, going to be fielded, bobbled, and it's on the ground at the 15-yard line. A scramble for it, and the Weevils have recovered. Oh, wow. The deep back for the Bulldogs bobbled the kick.
Number seven on the return, on the recovery. A.J. Bullock.
Okay. First and 10, Weevils, and be inside the red zone, following the turnover. Demayan Brown at the quarterback spot. Hayden Thomas, your lone setback. He'll line up in the pistol behind him. He's got a flanker to the right. Twin receivers go wide left. Brown. Pitch back to the wide receiver. Goes around the left end at the 10. Cuts it up at the 5. Into the end zone. No, did he step out of bounds? Nope, he's in there. Touchdown. For the Weevils on the run that time. Christian Gamage. And the Weevils are up 6-0 with only 13 seconds gone here in the first quarter.
Got a couple good blocks by the wideouts to the left side. So allowed him to get the corner turned.
Grassati on to attempt the extra point. Out of the hold of Caleb Jacobs. Everybody's set, snaps down, the kick's on its way, and it's through the uprights, and it's good. Weevils take an early lead, 7-0, following the turnover. We'll be back with more UAM football right after this timeout.
It's this time we'd like to recognize our partners who make a solid impact upon UAM Athletics. Our game day sponsor, Union Bank, Showcase of Floors, Commercial Bank, South Arkansas Rehab, Ag Up Equipment, Partners, BASF, Citizens Bank, Clark Contractors, Drew County Farm Bureau, Interform, Ryber, Paradigm Fitness, Domino's Pizza.
As we come back to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, the Weevils jump out to a 7-0 lead. And Sam, boy, you can't ask for it to write it up any better for the special teams.
Pretty good deal. But that kick just hit him in the wrong spot for him, the right spot for the Weevils.
And bobbled the kickoff. Weevils recovered at the 15, and one play took it in for the score as Gamage getting his first rushing touchdown of the year. As the wide receiver. Don't forget, next week we'll be on the road. We travel to Searcy to take on the Bisons of Harding University. 6 o'clock kickoff next Saturday from Searcy. We'll be there to bring you all the play-by-play here on the UAM Sports Network. 14:47 left to play first quarter. And I said it didn't take long. 13 seconds gone here in the quarter, and the Weevils are on the board. All right, everybody set. We're ready for the kickoff again. Duhon puts this one high, end over end again in the air. It's going to be fielded by Troy Henderson at the goal line. Back up over the 10 to the 15. Going to be run into a black wall there as the black jerseys of UAM swarm him up. Looks like leading the way for the Weevils on the tackle is going to be Timothy Gordon.
Another good kick. He's getting some good distance on the first two of them so far.
As put him down, they'll start inside their own 20. Actually spotted at the 15-yard line. First and 10 for the Bulldog offense. And they'll spread the field to start it here. They got twin receivers here to the wide side. Going to leave it with a tailback up the middle. He'll get it out to the 16, the 17, pushing the pile forward out to about the 19-yard line. That time, that big offensive line just got in and helped push him up the field.
Exactly. And they are some big guys.
On the carry that time was Ethan Hitch. Again, no huddle, quick snap, wanting to throw, looking. Throw it to the flat, up to Hitch again out of the backfield. He stumbles and falls forward out close to the 24. Going to be about a yard shy of the first down.
Iverson on the tackle.
Third down and one for the Bulldogs from their own 24-yard line. The quarterback, Scott Pfeiffer. Pfeiffer calling for the snap, hands it off to Heiss again. Heiss tries to find the seam, not going to get there. He stopped at the line of scrimmage for no gain. No gain on the play, and the Weevils defense swarms him, and the Bulldogs are going to have to punt it here on fourth down. So good defensive stop for the Weevils. They'll send on the punting unit. Going back deep for UAM is going to be Christian Gomage. Man, it had the touchdown earlier this evening. 7-0, Weevils with the early lead, 13-13 to go. Bulldogs go three and out on their first possession. As they'll show punt. Now they're going to fake it. And motion, so it'll be a backup 5 yards.
Punter missed the count there and started a little early. That'll definitely make them punt it now, I would think.
It was fourth and about three. They actually lost a yard and a half on that last play, and now you're going to be looking at fourth down and about eight from inside your own 20 at the 18-yard line where they'll spot the football. So the punter's going to be standing in his own five when he gets the snap. Christian Gomage back deep. Low wobbly kick toward the sideline away from Gomage. Going to hit it to 45. Roll up to midfield, and the Weevils are going to get excellent field position.
Looks like he tried to kick it away from Gomage. Maybe he knows something we don't know.
They have it first and 10 with excellent field position, a short field to work with, a 7-0 lead. The Weevils on top. They've run one play. It was good for a 15-yard touchdown scamper by Gamage. Again, your running back is Hayden Thomas. Your quarterback, Demian Brown. They got the tight end inside. He'll work line up as an H-back. That's Ian Meesh. Twin receivers come wide right, ball on the left hash mark. Brown hands off to Thomas. Thomas across midfield. He'll get a couple yards out of it, down to about the 48-yard line.
Carried by number 21, Hayden Thomas.
Hayden Thomas with the carry. Number 32 for the Bulldogs. That's going to be Richard Silva, the linebacker, in on the stop for them. Second down and eight. Twin receivers to either side this time. Took the tight end out. Brown wanting to throw. Straight drop. Has all day. Looking over the middle. Finds a man. Complete. That's Cross. I believe that is Isaiah Cross. Yep, like the catch. And that'll be a Bull Weevil first down.
Good protection. Really good throw.
Move the chains. First down at the 34-yard line. Same formation. Twin receivers either side. Brown again wanting to throw. Quick hitch pattern out there in the flat. Complete again. Be a short gain of about 4 yards on the play. Weevils quickly back to the line of scrimmage with no huddle. Second down and six. This time he'll leave it with Thomas Hayden hitting the backfield, still on his feet now, and finally tripped up at about the 30-yard line. So he's going to gain a couple of yards, but good hard running there by Hayden Thomas.
And number 30, Zach Roberts on the tackle.
Spot it back at the 31, so actually no gain on the play. It's going to be third down and a long six for the Weevils from the Bulldog, 31-yard line. Demayan Brown, your quarterback, straight drop. Steps up in the pocket, fires into flat. It's complete again. Good for the first down. They'll go inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. Is that 81?
Yes,
Nick Howard making the catch over there for the Weevils. We'll move the chains. It'll be good for the first down and right at the red zone at the 20, make it the 19-yard line. Actually, the ball just inside the 20-yard line. Trip receivers come wide right. One wide left. Bulldog rush four. Brown forced out of the pocket, rolling to his right, looking, he's going to keep it himself. To the 15, to the 10, sidesteps a man, hit from behind and brought down at the 6-yard line. Demayan Brown, not only can he beat you with his arm, he can beat you with his legs.
Really, really good job right there. They were pretty good coverage. He got outside the contain.
That was good for another first down, so it's first and goal to goal down at the 7-yard line, 6-yard line is where they've got it spotted. At the 6. Cross will split wide to the left, tight inside here to the short side of the field, ball in the right hash mark. Thomas looking for a hole up the middle. He goes inside the 5, down to about the 3-yard line, make it the 2. Hayden Thomas on the carry. Second and goal from the 2-yard line. Hand off again. Thomas cuts it back to his left. Going to be hit at the 1 and stopped shy of the goal line. Well, it looked like it was a big hole there.
That's what I was thinking. Looked like he was going to get in on that one.
But it closed quickly. Third and goal from just inside the 2-yard line, just outside the 1. Weevils leading 7-0, 9:19 to play in the opening quarter. Brown takes the snap, again leaves it with Thomas. This time he's into the end zone for the score. You know, 3 straight plays right up the middle, right behind those big centers and tackles.
On that play right there, he hit the line a little harder, a little more impetus than he had the previous 2 plays. Another good drive, though.
Weevils go 50 yards. Put more points on the board. Grisani's on to attempt the extra point out of the hold of Jacobs again. Kicking into the south end zone, right toward Weevil Pond. Snaps down. They'll get it on the way, and it is good. 14-0. Weevils take the lead here with 9:09 to play in the first quarter. We're back with more UAM football after this timeout.
Southwestern 0 and your UAM Bar Weevils 13.
Back here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, Sam Johnson, the Weevils put together a nice drive after the defense held the Bulldogs, got the ball at midfield, and were able to punch it in.
Yes, we did. Defense really did good to hold them and make them kick, and it was kind of a bad punt. We got some good field position after that punt exchange, so things looking up for the Weevils in the beginning.
They apparently the kick was no good. I thought he signaled good. It's still 13-0 on the scoreboard.
Both officials under the goal under the goalpost, both of them
held their hands up. Yes, I thought so.
Yeah, both of them did.
The scoreboard still says 13-0, so we'll have to go with that. Weevils get set to kick it off again. Duhon will tee it up once more. Back deep is Troy Henderson. And he'll stand at his own 5-yard line awaiting the kickoff. Again, Duhon last week put every kickoff inside the 10. The last one carried all the way to the goal line. This one, another high end-over-end kick right toward the pylon. Going to be fielded at the 3. Henderson back up over the 10. 15, 20, 25. Tripped up and brought down out near the 30-yard line. So a nice return of 27 yards on the return.
Jaden McCrary on the tackle.
And that's where the Bulldogs will start their second possession of the ball game, trailing the Weevils 13-0. They'll start at the 30-yard line, 1st and 10. The quarterback, Scott Pfeiffer, the lone setback beside him is Ethan Heisch. He'll line up on the right side. Twin receivers come wide left. Hand off to Heisch again, trying to get it to the edge. Weevils are there to stop him for a loss. Back at the 26-yard line.
Keontae Featherston.
Featherston, he's one of the leading tacklers on this defense for the Weevils. He came a long way from the secondary to make that stop.
And he came in a hurry, too.
A loss of 2 on the play, 2nd down and 12. Pfeiffer wanting to throw. Straight drop, looking over the middle, finds his tight end complete. No gain on the play as it's right down the line of scrimmage. As it was complete to Jacob Karsak. But your linebacker was right there in his hip pocket.
Covered him tight all the way across the field.
They're going to give him a gain of 2 up to the original line of scrimmage at the 30-yard line. So it'll be 3rd down and 10. Obvious passing down. Weevils will rush 4. They've had 4 down linemen. Pfeiffer wanting to throw, steps up. Ball batted at the line of scrimmage and going to go incomplete. Getting a big hand up there to knock it down for the Weevils is going to be Maurice. I don't have my good glasses on. What's his name? Number 92. Maurice Lovelitz. 92 for the Weevils. 4th down and 10. They'll punt it away again. Gamage again back deep for UAM. 13-0. Weevils on top. Another wobbly kick off the side of his foot, angling toward the sideline. Going to go out of bounds. Up around midfield, and the Weevils once again. The defense is going to hand them a short field to work with.
Exactly. The punter's having a hard time. It looked like we were on an all-out rush. And I don't know. Something's gotten his head. That's the second one he's kind of shanked off to the side.
So for the second time, following the fumble that the Weevils took in for a score, going to start at midfield again. Only took them 6 plays to get in last time from 50 yards out. Got a new running back, Gary Furman. Furman had the longest run from scrimmage last week at Northwest of 65 yards on his first carry of the game. Play action pass, though. Brown wanting to go deep, trying to buy it all. Got a man open at the 5. Touchdown, Weevils. Wow. Jermaine Gibson on the catch for the Weevils. A 50-yard strike from DeMayan Brown.
Perfect pass. He never broke stride. He beat his man pretty much at the line of scrimmage. All he had to do was run then.
Gibson with the catch and the touchdown. Weevils are up 19-0 here. And let's see. We're going to kick the extra point and not go for the 2 after missing that last one. We're going to try it again. Grisati on out of the hold of Jacobs, Caleb Jacobs. Everybody set. Good snap this time. Kicks on its way, partially blocked at the line of scrimmage, and no good. So 19-0 our score, 7:27 to play in the first quarter. Weevils are on a rampage. We'll be back right after this timeout.
19.
As we come back to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, Weevils lead at 19-0. This one's going to carry into the end zone for an automatic touchback. And the Bulldogs will get it at their own 25-yard line to start.
Maybe we might need to give him a chance at the extra point.
He's got the leg for it, that's for sure. That's Duhon who kicked it. All right, first and 10 for the Bulldogs, looking for their first down of the ball game. The quarterback, Scott Pfeiffer, wanting to throw on first down. Steps up in the pocket. Now he's forced out. He'll run it himself. Out over the 25. He's hit and has his leg cut out from under him at the 30-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5 on the play.
Robert Iverson on the tackle.
Robert coming up from his linebacker spot. He's kind of a spy on the quarterback. He plays the middle linebacker, that Mike linebacker in there. And
looks like he's got some good lateral movement. He can go side to side real well.
They spot the football up at the 30-yard line. Then there must have been a flag on the play. They're going to mark off a penalty against the Weevils. I didn't see one. We were watching the play. Maybe we'll get a call. It'll be good for a first down, whatever it is.
I never saw the signal.
I didn't. They'll spot it at the 35, first and 10. Pfeiffer throws. This one batted at the line of scrimmage again up in the air. Going to fall incomplete. This time getting a hand on it's number 90 for the Weevils. And that is Johnny Taylor. 6'2", a redshirt freshman out of New Orleans, Louisiana. Got a hand on it. That one stayed up in the air. It could have been picked.
Exactly.
Second down and 10 for the Bulldogs. Hand off to Heist. Nope. Wants to throw again. Throws complete down to the 45. Breaks the tackle at the 40. Holding on for dear life. The Weevils will finally bring him down at the 25-yard line. That receiver's number 4. They don't list sizes on him.
Taylor touches.
That'll move the chains. It'll be really the first positive play that the Bulldogs have had all ball game. Quickly, they'll snap the football. Whistles are going to blow. And
like it's going to be procedure.
Procedure call against the Bulldogs. Going to back them up 5 yards. Apparently, the officials' microphone's not working tonight. We picked up the call from the officials. They'll start behind the chains, though. You know, now you have to see if you can overcome that mental mistake.
Exactly.
For the Bulldogs.
Exactly. You don't ever want to get a penalty right after you've had a big play.
Yeah. First and 15 from the right hash mark. Pfeiffer wanted to throw, looking to his left, going toward the end zone, laying out for it, not going to hold on to it. Number 88 was the intended receiver, and that is Shamar Crawford. He gave it all he had, but couldn't hold on to it in the end.
Looked like he had it until he went to the ground.
Second down and 15 now for the Bulldogs from the Weevil 29-yard line.
I'm going to change out the footballs.
Heish is the lone setback. Twin receivers come wide left again. They'll send twin receivers wide right into the boundary. Bulldogs moving from right to left on your radio, from south to north. Pfeiffer, quarterback draw all the way. He's going to slide forward after he crossed the 25. 16. He gets it back, and he's not even going to get back to the original line of scrimmage.
Scott Pfeiffer,
got back the penalty yardage.
Mark it just inside the 25. It'll be third down and long. Third and long for the Bulldogs. Crowd gets into it here for the Weevils. Pfeiffer straight drop, looking left, looking right. Now throws over the middle. The receiver falls down. It'll go incomplete. It'll be fourth down and 10.
That sets up a pretty long field goal attempt. They may try to go for it here on fourth down.
Yeah, you're almost in no man's land. It'd be about a 41-yard attempt from here, from the right hash mark, if they decide to kick it. Looks like they're going to leave the offense out there. Or do a quick pooch kick. Fourth and long. Pfeiffer, straight drop. Weevils bring everybody. He throws over the middle. It's complete at the 20, down to the 15. Going to be a yard or two shy of the first down.
Good play. Good play by the defense. Let him catch it, but not behind him.
Jack Pierce, the one that caught it for the Bulldogs, but they're going to turn it over on downs, and the Weevil offense will start at their own 16-yard line, first and 10.
Definitely the worst field position we've had to start from. Let's see what we can do from a long ways away.
19-0. Weevils have the lead. If you joined us late, opening kickoff was fumbled by the Bulldogs. Weevils one play went in 15 yards for the score. They forced a three and out twice on the Bulldogs and were able to capitalize on a short field from midfield to score both of those touchdowns. Brown hands it off to Thomas. Thomas hit at the line of scrimmage and not going to be much there for Hayden Thomas over that left side.
Not much push by the offensive lineman. Kind of hit his own, a wall of his own players there.
No gain on the play. Second down and 10. Weevils will send in number 20. That's going to be a different running back. Tristan Smith will be the lone setback now. Brown out of the shotgun. Twin receivers on either side. They bring the blitz. Brown steps up, throws over the middle. Going to be incomplete. Off the fingertips of his intended receiver there, Nick Howard.
Looked like it might be just a hair behind him, maybe. He had some room to run if he could have caught it.
And sometimes Brown throws that little short pass pretty hard. And that one had some zip on it.
Yes, it did.
So third down and a long nine now for the Weevils. Trips come wide right. Thomas is back in at the running back. Brown running, scrambling, going to throw this one away. They had the blitz coming, and Brown really had no chance to set up. He just had to get rid of it.
Yeah, fire alarm right there. They all got in there, looked like on the defensive line. He had to just try to save his life and throw it out of bounds.
So with 5:05 left to play and counting here in the first quarter, Weevils lead 19-0. They're going to be forced to punt it away for the first time here in this ball game. As the punter will be standing about the 3-yard line when he gets the snap. And we'll see if the Bulldogs try to bring the house. Nope, they're going to let him punt it away. High, spiraling kick. Bobbled and on the ground again, and the Weevils have it. Nope, they're going to say that the Bulldogs recovered. Number one for them recovered it.
DeAndre Scott.
Yeah.
It was really close.
The special teams for the Bulldogs, I mean, they already fumbled one and lost it. Fumbled that one, but got it back. And they'll have it at their own 44-yard line. It'll be first and 10 now for Southwest Oklahoma.
This may be their best field position to start off.
Kawan Talbert, the running back now. Pfeiffer, your quarterback. Play action, looking, in trouble, breaks the tackle in the backfield, but not going to break the second one. It's coming through once again. There's Robert Iverson there to make the stop for the Boll Weevils. UAM all kind of pressure on him though.
Exactly. He broke one tackle, but there was another. Iverson was sitting in wait.
A loss of four on the play. Second down and 14. Pfeiffer straight drop again. Throw a pass, flare pass out in the flat, complete to the back out of the backfield. He's up over the 45, up close to midfield. And they'll finally bring him down there. Going to bring up a third and long. There's a flag on the play.
I think we're going to have either a block in the back or a holding on the wide receiver to the side the pass was thrown.
Holding the call. Yep, holding the call against the Bulldogs. And to negate that run, we'll back them up 10 from the line of scrimmage, and it'll be second and 24.
Sometimes those holes by the wide receivers have a tendency to be the reason that back had some room.
Right.
Weevils lead it 19 to nothing here in the first quarter with 4:19 left to play. Second down in a while. Pfeiffer out of the shotgun. Twin receivers go wide right. Now whistles blow. And we'll have another stoppage of play by the officials. I think they're discussing the spot of the football, but it's right. Yeah, they're going to leave it at the 30-yard line.
Yeah.
It'll remain second down and be second down and 24. And the officials still don't believe it. But there was a loss of four on the first down play. And that's where the line of scrimmage was. So here we go. They're set now. Second and 24. Pfeiffer, again, out of the gun. Straight drop. Weevils rush four. He steps up in the pocket. Fires over the middle of the field. And it's going to hit the turf. Be thrown short. Somebody may have got a hand on his arm.
They did. I think it was number four.
They'll bring up a third down and 24 now for the Bulldogs.
They're getting really good rush with just rushing four. That's why he's having a hard time finding somebody open.
Third and 24, Pfeiffer. Drops again. Pressure coming from the backside. He tripped up and going to be sacked back at the 27-yard line. As coming up with the sack for the Weevils, he'll get credit for it. There was a couple of them there, but Demarius White in on the stop. I believe. So it's fourth down, another punting situation. Weevil should get excellent field position once again. With 3:34 to play here in the opening quarter, 19 to nothing, Weevil's on top. The punter gets a good snap. They can almost get the block. Cross almost got there. High, fair catch called for, it looked like, up near the 40-yard line, and that's where the Weevils will have it, first and 10.
That was a little scary there. He came in on the slide to catch it. Turned out okay, though.
Christian Gomage. Yep. That'll be first and 10 for the Weevils. Now they'll spot it at the 41-yard line. Hayden Thomas checks back in at the running back spot now for UAM. We'll see Isaiah Cross. Split wide to the left. We'll look for him. Trip receivers go wide to the left out there. Gibson. And one other one. Brown wanting to throw on first down. Throws short into the sideline. About 15 yards down the field, actually. That's short for him.
Exactly.
And the pass was intended there for Gibson. And we have second down and 10. Clock will stop with 3:12 to play here in the opening quarter.
He was motioning to his receiver. I think maybe his receiver might have ran
too deep
a
route.
A little bit of the wrong route, maybe. He was, looked like he was motioning him to come back a little.
Second down and 10 from their own 41. The Weevils with the football. Brown calling for the snap. Going to leave it with Thomas. Hayden picks his way. He's across 45 to midfield. Going to be very close to the first down. I believe he's got it. Hayden Thomas right up the middle. They'll move it to the 49-yard line of the Bulldogs, and that's going to be good for a first down. Hey, Thomas, the running back out of Kinder, Louisiana. First and 10, Weevils. Brown again. Play action this time. Throws into the sideline. Going to be incomplete. Intended out there for Nick. Nick Howard, the intended receiver. Pretty good coverage, though. Cornerback came up. Got there about the same time the ball did.
Exactly. He kind of ran out of room. He didn't quite. I don't believe if he'd had his hands on it, he would have had his feet inbounds, I don't think.
Second down and 10 now for the Weevils from the Bulldog 49. Maybe H-back over on the right side. That's the tight end. A little cross buck in the backfield. Handoff goes to Thomas. A flag comes in. Thomas gets it down close to the 45-yard line. But I believe we're going to have a holding call against the Weevils. Yep. A four-yard run, but we'll negate that. They'll mark it off from the infraction, which the flag is down at the 46, I believe. Well, we're going to come back to the line of scrimmage and mark it off. Okay. It'll remain second down, though. It'll be second down and 20 for UAM. We've got 2:29 to play here in the first quarter. Boy, it seemed like this first quarter has gone
on. That's what I was thinking.
Forever.
A lot of passing, incompletions.
19-0. Weevils have jumped out on top here in the first quarter, looking for more. On second and 20, Brown out of the gun, straight drop. They rush four. Brown with all day. Now goes down the middle of the field for Cross, and it's just a little high. Over the outstretched hands of Isaiah Cross. Down at the 20-yard line. He was open, too.
Right down the middle.
Running a post pattern. Third and long. Caleb Jacobs will check in as a wide receiver. He'll split wide to the left. We'll have trips out there. Nope, now Jacobs will come out. Going back in for him is going to be Arlie Lee. They'll leave Thomas in the backfield. Trips to the wide side of the field. They bring the blitz. Pass thrown. It's going to be a wide receiver screen. But I believe Demian Brown had to just going to unload that one.
Pretty good rush. I think he had to turn it loose a little quicker than he anticipated.
It'll be fourth down and 20 now for the Weevils. For the second time, they'll have to punt it away. Second time here in this quarter. Weevils lead at 19-0.
Troy Henderson back deep for
the Bulldogs. All right. He'll be standing at his own 20-yard line. Good snap. Another high spiraling kick. This one turns over. Drives him all the way back to the 15. He'll make the catch. Didn't call for a fair catch. He tries to run it out of there. Going to lose ground back to the 10-yard line. Henderson in a crowd. Never called for the fair catch. Weevils had the special teams right there to make the stop. All the way back at the 10-yard line. So if you look at that, that's a 51-yard punt. 19-0. Weevils lead it. Under 2 minutes left to play first quarter.
I think if I would have been the deep man, I believe I'd have called for the fair catch. That could have not turned out too good for him.
Scott Pfeiffer stays in at quarterback for the Bulldogs. He'll hand it off right side. Got a pretty good room out over the 15, out to the 18-yard line. Is that's going to be Ethan Heisch on the carry. Ethan, not a very big back.
Well, his carry by number 15, Ethan Hinch. He is tackled on the
play. Hinch gets it out to the 18-yard line. So a gain of 8 on the play. Second down and 2. This Bulldog team has struggled here in the first quarter to get any kind of offense going. Pfeiffer wanting to throw. In trouble, going to be sacked for the second time this evening. Hitting through to make the sack for the Bow Weevils is going to be Gerard Washington, a 6'4 redshirt freshman out of River Ridge, Louisiana.
Number 92, Maurice Sloan.
And a loss of 1 on the sack, so it'll be third down and a long 3. a loss of two. We'll call it third and four.
Weevils continue to get a good pass rush out of their front four.
Pfeiffer hands it off right side. Heish out over the 20, close to the 25. He's going to have the first down. As he'll spot it all the way out at the 26-yard line. I think the Weevils were expecting a passing play.
Exactly. Pretty good size hole on the left side.
Weevils still with four down linemen. First and 10 for the Bulldogs from their own 26. Pfeiffer looks into the sideline now. Plenty of time on the play clock, 12 seconds. They'll line back up. Here we go. Pfeiffer bobbles a snap, wanting to throw it. Fires. It's going to be almost intercepted. In and out of the hands of the defender, Greg Hooks. I think Greg saw the end zone in his eyes.
Yeah, he saw the lights.
Because he stepped up, played it perfectly, and it just hit him in the chest.
Yeah, hit him in the wrong spot.
And you can tell he's disappointed in himself. And there's a timeout on the field. At the end of the first quarter is in the books. 15 minutes have gone. It's 19-0. The Weevils have the lead here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. We'll be back with more UAM football in just a moment.
That quarter took 40.
Fans, at this time, we would like to recognize our partners who make a solid impact upon UAM Athletics. We'd like to first recognize our game day sponsor, Union Bank. We'd also like to recognize Showcase of Forms, Commercial Bank, South Arkansas Rehab, Add Up Equipment, Gardens, BASF, Citizens Bank, Clark Contractors, Drew County Farm Bureau, Interfarm, Ryber, Paradigm Fitness, Domino's Pizza, Hampton Inn, Holiday Inn, and Days Inn, Mid-South City, Jefferson Regional Medical Center, Mainline Health Systems, Sea Arc Eye Care, and the Mecca Restaurant. Thank you for your continued support of UAM Athletics.
It'll be second down and 10 as we get set to start the second quarter. Weevils lead at 19-0. They're going to hand it off to Heish up the middle again. He's across the 25 and going to be out close to the 30-yard line. Gain three on the play.
Finding a little more of a hole every once in a while there.
That was Talbert on the carry. He's a back end now for the Bulldogs. Third and long. Third and seven. Pfeiffer wanting to throw. Looking. Going deep down the field into a crowd. It's going to be almost intercepted. Oh, my. One tipped it. One Weevil tipped it. And then the other one couldn't hold on. The bobble. Wow. But great defense. That's triple coverage down there.
Bryson LeBlanc.
Is he the one that tipped it or he the one that couldn't hold
He's
on?
He's the one that couldn't hold on to it.
He bobbled it. I think it was Greg Hooks who tipped it in the air. And LeBlanc, like I said, bobbled it, had it in every fingertip that he had, but just couldn't hold on to it. We got an injured player down on the field for Southwest Oklahoma. Don't forget, next week we will be on the road. We'll travel up to Searcy to take on the Bisons of Harding University. Boy, you know, you go up there, you see that single wing, it's tough to play. You got to tackle everybody coming out of the backfield and still look for the ball.
And there's usually the one that's got the ball, you still haven't found it.
But they have been very effective with that at Harding University. We'll get to travel up there, see Mr. Billy Morgan and the other crew.
Was the injured player the receiver?
Yes, it was. Number four, that's Taylor Tosh. He gets up and goes off the field under his own power, so that's good to see. Weevils with a 19-0 lead. We're just underway to start the second quarter. It's going to be fourth down and seven for the Bulldogs when play resumes. Both teams are still on the respective benches talking on the sidelines following the injury timeout that we had on the field. Going back deep for UAM is going to be Gommage, Christian Gommage. He's handling the return duties this evening.
He hadn't had his hands on the ball since that first play on the first touchdown.
As he'll stand about his own 35 to await the punt. Good snap. Another wobbly's off the side of the foot kick. Hits it for the 45 of UAM. Takes a short bulldog bounce down to about the 43-yard line. It'll be down there. Once again, the Weevils are starting on the other side of the 40.
About 29 yards on the punt. He's having trouble with that. I can't really figure out exactly what part of his motion where he can't hit that ball.
First and 10, Weevils. Now they'll spot it up at the 43-yard line. First and 10 from their own 43. Our running back this series is going to be Tristan Smith. Brown will stay in at quarterback. Twin trip receivers go wide right. Got a tight end to the short side. Now they'll go empty backfield. They're going to shift. Boom, that's going to be Arlie Lee. Going back, take the wild Weevil snap. They'll direct snap it to him. He'll get about a yard out of it.
I wondered what you were going to call that.
Wild Weevil?
Wild Weevil.
A direct snap. Your receiver was lined up on the outside. Then he comes back and they shift. And
exactly.
Direct snap it to him. Your quarterback, Brown, he actually went out as a wide receiver to line up. All right. We'll go back to a traditional set now. Brown at quarterback. Brown. Leaves it up the middle. Going to be a short gain there. Once again on the carry, that is Tristan Smith. There wasn't a hole there. There was not much of a hole there for him to run through.
No, not so ever there.
Gain of one, third down and nine for the Weevils now.
Looks like Brown could pull that, maybe be running free out here around the end.
On third down and nine. Twin receivers on either side. Brown wanting to throw. They rush five. He throws into the flat. Going to be incomplete. This pass was intended for Arlie Lee. By the time they brought, it looked like five on the blitz.
At least five.
Yeah, had somebody coming from the outside. Weevils are going to be looking at fourth down and nine from their own 44-yard line. Punting unit's going to come on.
They've been kind of sputtering a little the last few possessions.
Zachary Grisotti handling the punting duties. They're still going to send Henderson back there deep for the Bulldogs as he'll stand at his own 20-yard line. Good snap to Grisotti. Another high booming kick. Turns it over again on the spiral. Henderson's going to let this one hit the ground. Takes a bulldog bounce back up the field. It hit at the 9, going to bounce back up to about the 13-yard line. But still, anytime you can pin the other team back inside the 20, feel like your special teams has done their job.
Exactly.
We've got 13 minutes left to play here in the first half. 19-0 our score. The Weevils, as you said, Sam, they kind of looked a little lackluster.
A little shaky on the offense.
Last two or three series, you know, but they started out.
I think we need to get DeMayan a little more involved in the running part of the game.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Pfeiffer still your quarterback. Heiss, your running back. Handed off to Heiss. He's straight up the middle. He's out close to the 29-yard line. So that's going to put it up at the 29. Gain of five on the play. Second down and five. We will stay in a four-man front defensively. Pfeiffer again hands it off to Heiss. Picks his way. He's hit at the line of scrimmage. And he's going to get a yard, maybe two, out of it as he'll carry it out over the 30 to the 31.
Several Weevils met him at the point of attack there.
Gain of two. It'll be third down and three now for the Bulldogs. Need to get just shy of the 35, their own 35 for the first down. Pfeiffer calls for it. Heiss, left side, turns the corner. He's got the first down as he goes across the 35. And they'll move the chains for the Bulldogs. And I think that the Bulldogs are trying to establish some type of running game.
Got to.
It's first and 10 for the Bulldogs from their own 36 now. Pfeiffer on first down. Hand off to Heiss, trying to come right side. Breaks a tackle out over the 35, the 40. Going to be tripped up and finally brought down out around the 42, 43-yard line.
Missed a chance in the backfield to get him, and then he got around the corner and
made a nice gain, 7 yards.
7 yards. Really good run.
Second down and three. Quickly back to the line of scrimmage. No huddle. They'll call the play. Hand it off to Heiss again. Like the sixth time in a row he's carried. This time he's met. It's going to be a short gain of a half a yard. Weevil stood him up, and they had the hole blocked. Big number 99. Trey Hand. Third down and three. No gain on the play. Here comes the third down play. Third and three. Pfeiffer wanting to throw. Looking over the middle. Fires to the tight end. It's caught. Loses the football. It's loose on the ground. And the Weevils are going to fall on it. UAM will come up with the second turnover of the ball game. Nice hit there that knocked the ball loose.
Receiver was trying to make sure he was going to get that first down, and when he got hit, ball came loose.
And the Weevils will take over inside the 40.
They had that running game going, and then they decided to throw. I might have tried to run it two more times.
There's some discussion. There may have been a flag over there on the far sideline on the Bulldog sideline. 19-0, Weevils lead it. 10:36 left to play here in the opening half, first half. As the ball right now is spotted at the 36 of Southwestern Oklahoma.
Going to the review.
Okay.
New to the GAC this year is the opportunity to challenge.
So as we do that, 19-0. We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more UAM football in just a moment. .10:36 left to play here in the first half. There's an official review going on down on the field. 19-0, the Weevils have the lead. If you joined us late, we'll kind of recap the scoring for you. Weevils kicked it off to the Bulldogs, and they bobbled the opening kickoff. It was recovered at the 15. One play later, Gamage ran it in for the first down. Christian Gamage ran it in for the touchdown. They hit it on an end around. Grisotti added the extra point. Weevils were up 7-0. Weevil defense come out and forced a three and out on the next possession by the Bulldogs. Got the punt, and Weevils took over at midfield. It took seven plays for him to drive 50 yards. Hayden Thomas punched it in from 2 yards out. The extra point was no good, so we led 13-0. Weevils forced another three and out on the third possession by the Bulldogs, and again took over at midfield. Following a short punt, it took one play, 50 yards, as Nick Howard caught the pass and went into the end zone from Demian Brown. Point after attempt was no good, and that's where we are, 19-0.
They were reviewing whether that was a fumble or not, or a completed pass, and
they ruled it incomplete.
If it was complete, the Bulldogs would have the ball.
First down, yeah. And a first down?
Yes. No. It looks like it's going to be like a, I don't know, not quite a yard.
It was third and short. And they threw short across the field. The receiver caught it, had the first down, then fumbled the football, or we thought was a fumble. Now there's still some discussion. I see another official going back to the tent to try and figure it out. Sometimes these reviews, they're not supposed to take very long.
So. Exactly.
But sometimes they take a long time.
I think they go over there looking for one specific thing, and they find something else that they hadn't thought about sometimes, it seems like.
You know, if they rule it as a completed pass and then the ground caused the fumble, okay, it should be a first down for the Bulldogs. If the ball came out before he hit the ground,
it's an incomplete pass.
Or did he have possession of it?
Exactly.
And then the Weevils recovered.
He kind of had his back turned to us. We couldn't really see the ball as to whether or not he had control of it.
So we're waiting.
Something's not suiting him. Looks like Coach Jackson is kind of perturbed about it, whatever they're telling him. He's not going for it much.
He's almost out on the hash mark with the team and the three officials that are out there. And again, we apologize to you back home that it's taken so long for this review and decision-making by this officiating crew. 19-0 our score. Weevils have the lead. 10:36 left to play here in the first half. As the official's microphone has not been working, so we won't get an explanation from him other than what we can tell by his hand gestures. As
don't look like he's going
to. It looks like he's going to stay with the Bulldogs.
Looks like they have to be ruling it an incomplete
pass
for the Bulldogs to still have the ball.
So it should be fourth down and three. The offense is going to come out.
Down marker just changed to fourth down.
Fourth down and three. Weevils lead by 19. The Bulldogs will go for it. With a 10:36 to go in the opening half. Pfeiffer trying to draw him off sides with a hard snap count. Now he'll back up. We'll see a quick kick out of him. Trying to draw him off. Couldn't do it. Low line drive kick. Nobody back deep, of course, for the Weevils. It'll hit at the 20 and roll dead at the 15-yard line. So the Bulldogs were trying to draw him off sides.
Tried a little junior high action on him. Didn't work out good.
It'll be first and 10 from the 15 for the Bull Weevils here to start this possession.
The defense has played pretty well the whole half up to this point. The Bulldogs haven't gotten anything real easy, the yards they have made.
Yeah. All right, Hayden Thomas, the lone setback. Damian Brown, still your quarterback. Arlie Lee and Isaiah Cross split wide to the left. Brown, hands off. Thomas tries to get to the outside. He's cut off there. He'll get about four on the play, though. Nice run by Hayden Thomas. Looked like the play was designed to go inside the tackle, but he cut it outside.
Exactly.
So it'll be second down and six.
I keep thinking Brown's going to ride him in there in a minute and then yank it out. And
do a little RPO, huh?
There you go.
All right, on second down and six, Brown again out of the shotgun. They'll rush four. He's going to back up. Now rolls to his left, throws down the field, and it is going to be caught up near the 30-yard line. It should be good for the first down. Making the catch out there, his first reception of the night for the Bull Weevils.
Ben Callaghan.
Yeah. Ben, tight end out of Magnolia, Texas.
Brown put a little extra mustard on that one.
First and 10 Weevils. This time, the RPO, he pulls it. Now he's going to throw it. Wide receiver screen complete. He'll be out over the 30, out to the 33-yard line. He faked it in the gut of Thomas, pulls it out, and then comes up and fires it out in the flat. as it was complete to Isaiah Thomas, but a short gain of only 3 yards. Second down and 7. Ball's going to be on the right hash mark. Weevils moving from right to left as the shadows finally almost cover the entire field now. On a beautiful night in southeast Arkansas for football. Play clock down to 9. Brown calling for the football. Brown leaves it with Thomas again, right side. I believe that's maybe Furman in it, running back this time. Yeah, Gary Furman, number 26 in it, running back. No gain on the play on that one, so it's third and long. Give him a yard. Third and 6. Third down and 6 for the Weevils. 8:18 left to play here in the half. 19-0. Weevils with the lead here at home on the home opener, Parent and Family Day. On third and long, Bulldogs show blitz. They'll bring pressure up the middle, fires quickly across. Isaiah with the first down out across the 40-yard line to the 42.
Good route and good throw. They were showing the blitz, and then they backed out right at the last second.
Isaiah is a junior out of Texarkana, Texas, making the catch. First down, Weevils. DeMalion wanting to throw on first down. Long pass out here in the flat. It's going to be caught and out of bounds. Be a gain of about 5 on the play, maybe 4 on the play. Making the catch out here for the Weevils. That is
Devonnie Gibson.
So it will be second down and 7, a gain of 3 on that play. Furman stays in at the running back. On second down and 7, Brown leaves it with Furman, right side. He's tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Will ball forward for a yard out to the 46. And that's going to be about it. So the third down and 6.
We had a lot of this distance on third down, seems like, here lately.
Third and long. Under 7 minutes to play in the half. Weevils lead it 19-0. Furman will move over on the right side of Brown here on third and long. Now Furman goes in motion. Brown throws over the middle into a crowd. Nothing there. Goes incomplete. Intended for cross again. He ran just a hook pattern in the middle of the field.
Looked like similar to the last one we got the first down on. Pretty much the same play.
So the Weevils are going to send the punting unit on, it looks like. With 6:40 to play here in the half. 19-point lead. Let's play field position. Make them drive the length of the field. Henderson will go back deep again. As Grisotti's on to do the punting chores for the Weevils. Been hitting some beauties tonight. It's a low snap, bounces to him. He gets the punt off. Another high kick, though. This one will hit at the 20, bounds inside the 20 as it takes a Weevil roll to the 15, down to the 12-yard line. Another good punt from Grisotti.
About 39 yards.
Again, the Bulldogs will start inside their own 20, this time at their own 12-yard line. So they're, you know, their average starting position has been about the 20-yard line.
That's not very good for them.
Well, the Weevils has been up around the 40, 45.
Especially down 19-0 now. Yeah. You'd like to be up here a little further up the field.
Well, I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. They put it at the 13 instead of the 12, so it's first and 10. Pfeiffer stays in at quarterback. Twin receivers go to either side. Weevils will show a four-man front defensively, and that's what they'll do. They'll rush forward, drop 7 back. Pfeiffer wanting to throw, looking. Forced out of the pocket now, running into the sideline, going to throw it away. Good coverage down the field, and then some pressure finally got
excellent
to him.
Excellent rush, too. Brings up the secondary. Yes, the secondary really put the clamps on the receiver.
Yeah, it looks like A.J. Bullock was one of the first ones to get there. Second down and 10 now for the Bulldogs. Ball spotted at their own 13-yard line. Heist, the lone setback in the backfield. Trip receivers go wide left. One comes wide right. Pfeiffer Steps back, two-step drop, throws and complete to the tight end out about the 18-yard line. Going to be a gain of five, and then the Weevils will corral him there and bring him down. Yeah, I think the secondary has really been reacting quickly to those short passes.
Ashton Duncan on the tackle on that play.
Third down and five for the Bulldogs. Just outside their own 18-yard line. Pfeiffer wanting to throw again. Looking to his left. Fires over the middle of the field. It is caught well short of the first down. And a nice hit there by Arlie Lee. Number eight. Gibson.
It's the same route they ran a few plays ago where he had the review play on. Yeah. Almost the same receiver for sure.
Is a yard and a half shy of the first down. It's fourth down and about a yard and a half. They're going to have the offense line up again and try to draw the Weevils offside. And they may go for it here with 5:04 to play here in the first half. From their own 22-yard line, they're going to hand it off. They get it to Heiss. Heiss breaks through. He's got the first down out over the 25. He'll carry it out close to the 30-yard line. Gutsy call there by the coaching staff for Southeastern.
The Bulldogs have kind of got the run game going a little bit for them here. Maybe they ought to just keep running it.
They'll mark it out at the 29-yard line. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Pfeiffer again wanting to throw. Looking. Now he eaves it down the field as far as he can, overthrows everybody. Had man-to-man coverage down there. Wide receiver, number 88, was the intended receiver. That's Shamar Crawford. And the clock will stop with 4:23 to play here before halftime. Weevils lead it 19-0. Second down and 10. He's going to hand it off to Heiss. Heiss trying to go over the left tackle. He's caught from behind, and he'll gain a couple, maybe three. I'll see where they mark his forward progress. But again, that play looks like it's designed to go up right behind the tackle.
And he keeps cutting it outside.
Yeah. They did give him three on the play. It'll be second down and seven. Or should be third down. Third down and seven. Yeah. Twin receivers come wide right. Obvious passing down. They set up the screen, inside bubble screen, and Weevils are all over it. Going to lose yardage back to the 29-yard line.
Yeah, they said that play's not happening, guys.
Shane Crawford made the catch on the bubble screen on the inside to the wide receiver, but, yeah, UAM's defense was all over.
Yeah, they burst that bubble for him.
Fourth down and 10. They'll send the punting unit back out onto the field. As the punter is Dayton Thrower. And now a timeout call. With 3:27 left to play here in the first half, it's 19-0. The Weevils have the lead. We'll take a break with them and be back in just a moment.
Please help support our student athletes with this major facility improvement and upgrade. For more information on the Legacy Campaign and how to donate, please contact the UAM Athletics Office for more information. The Chipotle the football team will host OBU on September 23rd here at Cottonville Stadium, starting at 6 p.m. for our faculty and staff appreciation day, sponsored by Mid-South Sea. Students, at this time, pull out your tickets.
19-0. The Weevils have the lead. All the scoring came in the first quarter, Sam. And since then, Weevils kind of got shut out on offense.
Doing well on defense, though. Yeah. The Bulldogs haven't threatened to do any scoring on their own.
0-0. 1-6.
I thought I did that.
Again, that's 001642. If you have the winning ticket number, please see Assistant Athletic Director Mark Jones on the home sideline for further instructions.
Back here at Combo. What's going on?
Flag on the play. Runners run out at the 45-yard line.
Back here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, the Bulldogs punted it away, and it's
looks like we're debating a penalty.
Yeah,
it's going to be holding against the Weevils.
Gamage was on the return for the Weevils and got it back up near the 45-yard line, but
I think they caught one of our outside defenders for holding.
Okay, so we'll come back to the end of the play and mark it off from there. The end of the run, and that will mark it back.
Still got a good starting spot, though. The fort looks like it's going to be the first on the 45.
And that's where they end. They're going to mark it to the 35.
Excuse me there. Yeah. Forgot about the penalty.
There you go.
35.
3:20 to play in the first half. And what seemed like has gone on for a long time. An hour and 10 minutes old already to play 30 minutes of football.
Exactly.
All right, here we go. A lot of passing, a lot of incomplete passes. Handoff going to go up the middle. That's Thomas. Thomas cuts it to his left, now turns it up. He'll out of the 35, out to the 39-yard line. Big gain of four on the play for Hayden Thomas. Bring up second down and six.
Keep doing that right there. That might run the rest of the half. let them get a little drink of water or something.
Weevils have two timeouts remaining. And it's second down and six. Wide receiver screen complete. Out over the 45, midfield. First down and more. As making the catch is going to be Agent.
Giovanni Gibson, he is tackled on the play by number 37,
Donovan good.
Timmerson. Results of the play is a UAM Mole Weevil. Ball's carried by number 21, Hayden Thomas. 3-yard gain on the play, brings up second down and six. Pass complete to number 10, Isaiah Cross. He is brought down on the play by number 37, Donovan Jefferson. Results of the play is a UAM Mole Weevil. Number 7, Devlin Brown, the quarterback keeper. He is brought down by number 52, Cameron Guyton. 2-yard gain on the play, brings up second down.
We will still have the football with a minute 12 left to go here before half.
They've picked up two first downs on two wide receiver screens.
Demian Brown will keep it himself. 30, 35, going to be inside the 30 to the 25-yard line.
That's a play I've been calling for the whole half. I want to just see him run.
Move the chains. It'll be a first down. They mark it at the 26-yard line. First and 10 for the bullet for the Weevils. Brown again out of the shotgun. Yeah. You mean the phone's not going on the air?
This is incomplete.
You sure you got the program?
Yes.
And then on the run, a really nice pass.
So the Weevils go up on top 25-0 with 36 seconds left to go here before halftime.
The receivers really helped him out. They just kept running, kept trying to find an open spot.
And again, we apologize for our technical problems of dropping the line. We're going to have a timeout called on the field. As Weevils may be thinking about going for two here, you think?
I think so.
It
looked like Coach Jackson was signaling it from the sideline, maybe.
It's 25-0. Weevils on top. 36 seconds remain here before halftime. The Weevils just put together a nice drive. Started at their own 35-yard line, so a 65-yard drive that they put together. Demian Brown caps it off with a pass to Isaiah Cross from 22 yards out, I believe.
Hard for any defensive back to stay with them that long. Once that quarterback busts out of the pocket, and he whatever decision he makes is wrong.
Yeah.
He comes up, throws it by him. If he stays back, Demarion can run.
All right, they are to leave the offense out there and go for two here. Brown is the quarterback. Christian Smith going to be your running back. Twin receivers will go right. Twins come left. On the two-point conversion try here with the Weevils leading 25-0. Put a wide receiver in motion to the left side. Brown looking left, now throwing right, and it's going to be incomplete. Threw it down, trying to get it to Smith. Christian Smith out of the backfield. Just threw it down about his ankles.
And I think he's upset with himself, but I think he thinks he should have caught it.
All right, we'll take a break. We'll be back with more UAM football right after this. As we come back, the Weevils kick it off. Henderson fields it at the 9. He'll return it back over at the 20, out over the 30, the 40. Going to be all the way up close to midfield. Nice return by Henderson for the Bulldogs. Weevils lead it 25-0. We got 29 seconds left to go here before halftime.
Really good blocking finally for the Bulldogs. He hit the hole full blast.
They mark it up at the 48-yard line of the Bulldogs. Southwest has all three timeouts to work with if they choose. They'll send twin receivers wide to the right. Twins go wide left. Pfeiffer wanting to throw on first down. Steps up, in trouble, going to be sacked. And coming through for the Weevils is Rena Getter. Rena Getter, big defensive lineman from Shreveport, Louisiana. Third sack of the night against.
And they're letting the clock run.
10 seconds. Here before half, Pfeiffer again, straight drop. Now rolls to his right. Looking down the field, fires toward the sideline. Going to be incomplete. With 1 second left on the clock. Here before halftime. Pass was intended out there for Taylor Tosh.
Nice coverage again, too. Yeah. Secondary's played really well the whole half.
And the Weevils only rushing four, able to force him out of the pocket.
Exactly.
Second down and 18. They'll hand it off to Heiss this time. Heiss across the 45. He'll get back to about the original line of scrimmage. That's going to be the end of the half. here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium on the campus of the University of Arkansas at Monticello. Your UAM Bowl Weevils have a 25-0 lead over Wazoo, the Southwest Oklahoma State Bulldogs.
Really nice half by offense and defense.
And both teams will make their way to the locker rooms. We'll take a break here at halftime and try to have some halftime stats for you when we come back in just a moment.
UAM fans, this is the pride of Southeast Arkansas, your 2023 Bowl Weevil Marching Band. The UAM Marching Band is under the direction of Director of Bands, Dr. Kristen Zelnick, Percussion Professor, Dr. Steven Busman, Color Guard Captain.
We welcome you back here to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. We're at halftime where the Bowl Weevils lead 25-0 over Southwest Oklahoma State. Recapping the scoring for you, the scoring drives. Didn't take the Weevils long to get on the board after recovering the kickoff fumble by South Wazoo. One play, a 15-yard drive, it was a 15-yard rush by Christian Gommage, and the Weevils, just like that, were up 7-0 with only 8 seconds gone in the first quarter. Didn't take them long to do that. Weevils defense forced a three and out on the next possession, and that was with 9:09 left to play in the first quarter. Hayden Thomas, a 2-yard run. That ended up being a 9-play, 50-yard drive after the three and out. They forced them to punt. Weevils had it at midfield, and 9 plays later, Hayden Thomas takes it in the end zone. Weevils defense did another great job on the next possession. Forced them to a three and out. Once again, the Weevils got it at the 50-yard line. This time, it was Demian Brown connecting with Gibson. What's Gibson's first name?
Giovanni
Gibson. And that was a 50-yard pass play. One play, 50 yards. Gassati's kick was blocked. Where we stood at 19-0. And we still had 7:27 left to play in the first quarter. The only other scoring we had was late in the second quarter with 36 seconds remaining. UAM, Isaiah Cross with a catch, a 26-yard pass from Demian Brown again, his second touchdown pass of the night. And the two-point conversion failed, but it was an 8-play, 55-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 44 seconds. Weevils used the clock rather well on that last drive to get in and not leave much time on the clock here before halftime, and that's where we stand at the moment. 25-0, the Weevils leading Southwest Oklahoma State. Again, we've got more to come, more to do. We'll talk about some of the individual numbers when we come back in just a moment. We welcome you back once again here at halftime. Bull Weevils with a 25-0 lead over the Bulldogs of Southwest Oklahoma State. Sam Johnston's in the booth with me tonight. And Sam, you go back and just kind of look at the first half. It's been almost all UAM here in the first half.
Started off with on the opening kickoff with a bad miscue by the Bulldogs and been kind of downhill for them the rest of the way.
As you look at it, 25-0 our score here at the half. Weevils with 11 first downs. Southwest Oklahoma with only six. It was like their third or fourth possession before they picked up a first down. They've only been inside UAM territory, I think, one time. That was on a pass play that Weevils forced them to turn it over on downs. All right, let's go on with the stats here. This time they've rushing yards. Southwest Oklahoma State, 19 times for 51 yards on the ground. That's pretty good defense by the Weevils. UAM, 18 carries, 74 yards.
That's pretty good defense, too.
Yes, it is. As you go to the passing game here in the first half, Southwest 7 of 18 for 62 yards. UAM 11 of 20 for 148 yards. All of our success by both offenses really came in that first 6 minutes of the first half, quarter. Total plays, 37 for Southwest Oklahoma State, 113 total yards on the night. For UAM, 38 offensive plays, 222 yards.
Almost doubled them.
And you go back and look, punts, 2 for 2, and let's see. Time of possession, 15:48 for Southwest Oklahoma, 14:12 for UAM. So you go back and look. Maybe UAM didn't dominate that much in the ball game other than getting the breaks there at the first of the football game.
The Bulldogs special teams hurt them. Their punters giving the Weevils really good field position almost every time they've had the ball.
As we are at halftime, the Weevils lead it 25-0 here at the half. Next week we're on the road. We'll travel to Searcy, a 6 o'clock kickoff next Saturday from Searcy. And we'll have that ball game for you right here on KHBM 93.7. We got more to look at here in just a moment. We'll come back and give you the individual numbers, tell you who stood out for both teams when we return after this timeout. back here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. Boy, 2 minutes goes by quick when you're
exactly
doing something else, doesn't it? We're here trying to get our computer to work, and I understand from Ryan Toll, the SID, that live stats has not been working, which we knew that all night long. We hadn't had any live stats. We do have the paper stats here at halftime. As we said, the Weevils total offense, 222 yards on 38 plays. Southwest, 113 yards on 37 plays. Individually, let's run it down for you. For Southwest Oklahoma, leading ball carriers, Ethan Heisch, 13 carries for 59 yards. Actually, lost two, so 57 on the net end of it, averaging 4.4 yards per carry. Kajon Talbert, one carry for three, and Scott Pfeiffer, the quarterback. Of course, he's had a couple of sacks in there, so he's going to have a negative nine on the rushing on the night. Receiving, Pfeiffer's thrown it to four different receivers. His favorite receiver has been Taylor Tosh, five catches. Five targets, two catches for 46 yards, the longest being a 41. That was the only time that Southwest.
That's about the only real offense they had.
Jack Pierce, one catch for 9 yards. Ethan Heiss out of the backfield, one catch for five. And T.J. Easter, one catch for three. On the UAM side, here's what the Weevils have done. Hayden Thomas, your leading ball carrier on the night. He's had 9 carries for 29 yards. Longest was a 10-yard run. Averaging 3.2 yards per carry. Demayan Brown, like we talked about earlier in the ballgame, he beats you not only with his arm but with his leg. Three carries, 27 yards, and averaging nine times he scrambles out of that pocket to run the football. Christian Gamage had that one carry for 15 yards and a touchdown for the Weevils. That was the very first offensive play for UAM back early in the first quarter. Gary Furman got in and saw some action, three carries, 2 yards on the night for him. Receiving, once again, Isaiah Cross has been the favorite receiver on the night for Demayan Brown. Been targeted seven times, has five catches for 58 yards and a touchdown. The longest was a 26-yard touchdown score. Giovanni Gibson, five targets, three catches, 65 yards on the night and a touchdown. That longest being that
50-yard
touchdown pass. Nick Howard, two catches. He's been targeted four times, 14 yards on the night. And Ben Colligan, one catch, 11 yards. So, you know, last time we saw, I think last week, Demayan used seven different receivers that he had that he used. Right now he's got four that he's been throwing to tonight. But I think last week, you know, we're on track to play. They ran 38 offensive plays here in the first half, so you're looking at 76 if they do double that in the second half. I'm sure Coach Qualls and the way they run this offense with no huddle, he'd like to be on up in the 80s, close to 90 offensive plays. But both defensive, after UAM jumped out to a 19-0 lead, both defenses have tightened up.
Like we said earlier, the main thing the Bulldogs had that they didn't have much luck with, their punter.
Yeah,
he punted it five times for only 29, about 30 yards a punt. That's not very good. That's given the Weevils a really good field position, and they really hadn't had to do anything real long, throw a long pass or make a long run. They had the ball pretty close as soon as they got it.
We are at halftime here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. And don't forget, next week we're on the road. We'll travel to Searcy. Be another Great American Conference game. All the games are conference games here at the Great American Conference. There's 12 teams. Of course, six in Oklahoma, six in Arkansas. And you play an 11-game season and hope for the best when you come out of it there in November. As we are at halftime, the Weevils lead the Bulldogs of Southwest Oklahoma State. We'll be back with more at halftime in just a moment. Thank you. Once again, we welcome you back here to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. Had a good crowd on hand today on the campus today for Parent and Family Appreciation Day across the campus. Boy, the tailgating this afternoon was fabulous out there on the lawn and beside Weevil Pond. Had a great crowd stick around for the football game.
Saw lots of folks walking around waiting on the gates to be open. Having a good time.
As right now, the Weevils have a 25-0 lead over Southwest Oklahoma State. You know, we come out here, UAM deferred to the second half. So they're going to get the football to start in the second half. You know, Coach Jackson and Coach Qualls, they want to come out and see the offense get back on track here early.
I want to see them get the running game really going and not have to throw it.
Yeah.
We got several backs that they've gone substituted in and out.
As we're just a few moments away from the start of the second half, and both teams, some of the special teams are making their way out. A lot to talk about in the halftime, I'm sure, in the locker room.
Yeah. For the Bulldogs, for sure. They're trying to figure out who they can get that can punt it.
And
I'm like you, though. I know Coach Qualls wants to just put them out of their misery, maybe score right here on this first position, and then they may be ready to go warm up the bus.
Well, in college ball, there's no sportsmanship rule like there is in high school. 35-point lead in high school starts that clock to run it, but they don't do it in college football. So we'll play it all the way out. We got 30 more minutes of football coming your way here in just a few moments from Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium here on the campus of UAM. Sam Johnson joined me for the first time. Sam, I know it's your debut on the radio, but you're doing a fantastic job. So
thanks.
Far.
It's I'm not. I don't know a whole lot, but I can contribute here and there. It's been fun. I'm liking it.
How many years did you spend coaching on the high school level, junior high level?
29.
So you've seen a lot of football in your day.
15 of them in Warren.
Yeah, exactly. All right. We're going to take one more final break as we are at halftime. It is 25-0. The teams are starting to make their way out of the dressing room. We'll take this final break and come back with the start of the third quarter right after this timeout. As we get set to start the third quarter, the Weevils with a 25-0 lead over 𝗗𝗜𝗦𝗖𝗘𝗥. the UAM to receive the kickoff. First one we've seen tonight by Southwest. Going back deep for UAM is going to be Arlie Lee. On one side, and here on the other side is going to be the other wide receiver, Theron Bellard. As special teams there in the first half really hurt Southwest Oklahoma State. UAM was able to take advantage of some short field position, as Sam talked about. And we're able to capitalize on that. The kicker for Southwest Oklahoma State is Brandon McCary. He'll handle the kickoff duties. We're just about set to get this second half started. And Sam, what do you expect to see out of the Weevils? More of the same?
Sure.
That we saw in the first half?
I just think maybe they might try to concentrate a little more on the run game, maybe.
Okay. If
that doesn't pan out, they can go back to the throwing.
Kick going to be fielded at the 10. Returned up to the 15, the 20, 25. Sidesteps the tackler at the 30, 35. Turns on the jets. Is going to be tripped up in a shoestring tackle out at the 45-yard line. As on the return for the Weevils was Arlie Lee.
Last guy got a little bit of an ankle, or he was to the house.
You're looking at a 37-yard return on the kickoff, and the Weevils, again, start off with short field position.
Exactly. I was just fixing to say that. Really good field position.
From their own 47, Furman will get the start at running back here in the third quarter. Gary Furman, Kamayan Brown, your quarterback. They go with a tight end set to the wide side of the field, and an H-back on that side. Brown, play action, throws, complete to the wide receiver. It'll be a gain across midfield down to the Bulldog 44-yard line. Trying to see, was that Nick Howard that made the catch?
Yep, so.
Yep, Nick Howard making the catch here. Gain of 9 on the play. It'll be second down and 1. Leave this one with Furman. Furman hit at the line. He's not going to get it. Boy, he got stopped and then pushed backwards. So Furman, no gain on the play.
A little bit of stutter step on him. He couldn't really decide what to do, and then it was too late.
This time the Weevils go big. They'll send in a big tight end for the Weevils, DJ Russell. He'll line up here on the wide side of the field. Brown goes underneath center, almost an I formation. They hand it off to Furman straight ahead, and Furman, it'll depend on where they spot the football, whether he got the first down or not. I don't think he does. I don't think they're marking him short. Looking at this official here on this side. Going to bring up a fourth down and less than a yard.
Go for it.
Opening drive of the third quarter. Weevils leading 25 to nothing. The offense is going to stay out on the field. They're looking into Coach Qualls over here to see what the play is going to be, the offensive coordinator. They go heavy on the right side. Hand it off to Furman again. This time he's got the first down. As the offensive line got enough push that time for Furman to pick up the first
didn't
down?
Didn't get a lot, but I got just enough. Looked like he might have had about like a football to gain, a football length to gain. So.
That'll move the chains. It'll be a first down at the 42-yard line of the Bulldogs here. This opening drive, and how important is this opening drive to the Weevils? I mean, you can put the nail in the coffin if you can score.
Exactly, exactly. And, you know, they can work on stuff that they didn't work on in the first half maybe.
Brown, play action again, throwing, slant pattern, going to be in and out of the hands of his intended receiver. As that was Bullard, again, the intended receiver.
Really nice pass. He can, Demayan can hum that thing.
He can. He's got an arm.
And whether it's a short pass or a little more lengthy one, he's got a little something on it.
Trip receivers go wide right. One comes wide left for the Weevils. Ball on the left hash mark. Brown again out of the shotgun. He'll send Lee in motion to the short side of the field. Arlie lines up. Now twins on either side. Brown, straight drop, steps up, fires, going to be through the hands of the intended receiver. That's Nick Howard.
Pass intended for number 81.
He was in a crowd, too.
Exactly.
A couple of defenders there. It'll bring up a third down and 10 now for the Bo Weevils.
The receivers are having a little problem holding on to it right here, right off the bat.
Third down and 10. Furman stays in at the running back spot.
Looks like they might be coming with the blitz.
Four linemen, they'll back off on the blitz, rush four. Brown forced out of the pocket, he'll run it. He's at the 35, the 30, the 25. First down and more as he runs out of bounds down near the 20-yard line.
A running quarterback is a really nice thing to have.
Demian Brown moves the chains. Gain of 17 on the play, and how about that? We've got a first down.
Had a good rush on him, and he found one little hole, and after that, he's hard to, he's got good speed. He's hard to catch up to.
First and 10 from the 20. Brown pulls it out, going to keep it himself again. Turns the corner. He's inside the 20, down to about the 16-yard line. That'll be a gain of four. Yeah, they're running a little bit more RPOs, run pass option.
We didn't do that much in the first half.
We've got an injured Bulldog down on the field with 11:49 to play here in the third quarter. The opening drive by the Weevils. They'll have it second down and six. When play resumes, we'll take the break with them. UAM, no, we're going to keep it right here. The player's up and going, so we're good. He's up and going to walk off the field under his own power. We'll keep it here.
He kind of got clocked pretty good.
He wasn't sure which sideline he was supposed to go to.
Exactly. One of the Weevils tried to help him up, and he was shaking his head like, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about my balance here.
Weevils lead it 25-0. That was our score at halftime. Weevils put 19 on the board in the first 6 minutes of the first quarter and then scored just before halftime to take this 25-0 lead, and now they're knocking on the door inside the red zone. And it will be second down and six. I believe they got it spotted at the 16-yard line when play resumes, as both teams are still huddled up on the sideline. But this is what, I mean, if UAM punches it in here, you almost think, boy, they took a little, lot of wind out of the sails.
Exactly. The defense for UAM can really – you know, back off the receivers, let them catch it in front of them. Just don't let them get behind them and just let the clock run.
Second down and six. Furman stays in at the running back spot. Isaiah Cross will split wide right along with Gibson. Twin receivers come wide left as well. Ball's on the left hash mark. Brown checks the defense. Wanting to throw. Brown now in trouble. He's going to be sacked for the first time tonight. Coming through for the Bulldogs is R.J. Powell. That time, Demian Brown just stood in there too long.
Yeah, he held on to it too long. I thought he was going to throw it away, but.
Going to be a loss of six, maybe a loss of five on the play. Third down and 11. So third and 11 now for the Weevils. Ball back out at the 21-yard line. On third and long. They bring the pressure outside to the end zone. Caught, touchdown, Bo Weevil. Nick Howard, once again, his second receiving touchdown of the night. Perfectly thrown ball from Demian Brown.
He gets off the line of scrimmage without much hands put on him. He's free running, and Demian can really throw that route.
He had a good touch on the football. Weevils go up 31-0. Grisotti will come on to attempt the extra point.
Good protection by the offensive line that time. He could stand in there and look around. So, nice pass.
All right, Grisotti will attempt the extra point. Last two have been blocked. See if they can get this one off. Snap is down. The kick's on its way, and this one is good.
On top of the field house.
32-0. Weevils lead it. 11:03 to go here in the third quarter. We'll be back with more UAM football right after this timeout.
Fans, the UAM is in the process of promoting the Legacy Campaign. The Legacy Campaign is focused on enhancing the support of student athletes through major facility improvements. Please help support your student athletes with this major facility improvement and upgrade. For more information on the Legacy Campaign and how to donate, please contact UAM Athletics.
Weevils 32-0. Weevils lead it. They'll kick it off. Fielded by Henderson at the 15. Up to the 20, 25. They're going to be up to the 30-yard line. And that's where the Bulldogs will start their first possession of the second half. At their own 30-yard line.
Pretty good coverage on the kickoff.
Weevils marched it down the field 52 yards on the drive. Unofficially, 11 plays, and it was a 21-yard pass play from Demayan Brown to Nick Howard, his second receiving touchdown of the night. Grisotti added the extra point, and that's where we're at. 32-0.
Really nice pass by Brown on the touchdown.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Pfeiffer will be your quarterback. He's the starter tonight, Scott Pfeiffer. He's got Heiss in at running back. He started the night at running back. Going to leave it with Heiss. Heiss finds a seam over the right tackle. He's out over the 30 to the 35, all the way to mark him at the 35-yard line. He gets a hole quick, doesn't he?
Yes, sir.
Gain of 5, almost 6 on the play. We'll call it 5. It'll be second down now for the Bulldogs. Twin receivers come wide left and wide right. Heiss again, right up the middle this time. Heiss good for a couple, and that's off. Mark him out almost to the 38-yard line.
The Weevils can kind of afford to let him run for a few yards here off and on with the big lead.
Just not let him get to the end zone.
Exactly.
Third down and 1. Pfeiffer wanting to throw on third and short. Fires over the middle, over the left side. Make it. It's caught and out of bounds. And it will be good for the first down. So they mark it out to the 43, and that's where the Bulldogs will have it. They pick up the first down.
Shamar Crawford on the reception.
On first down, quickly wanting to throw again. Another quick turnaround, a little hook pattern there, and caught out near midfield. That's a big receiver, isn't it?
It's big.
We'll try to catch his number. I think he's going to be one of the tight ends. He's lined up as a wideout.
80.
Yeah, I don't have the weights listed on here, but Jacob Karsak.
My sheet says 6'3", 230.
Second down and 3, a gain of 7. Hand off to Heiss again. Heiss carries it across the left side into Weevil territory to the 48. Needed to get almost to the 47 for the first down, so it's going to bring up third and short now. Third down and short for the Bulldogs. No huddle. Here they go again.
Got a nice little drive going.
On third and less than a yard. Heiss just a handoff, hitting the backfield, and he's going to be sacked for a drop for a loss. Boy, what penetration the Weevils had. That offensive guard was pulling. And the defender for UA Hill, he just took the guard and running back and everybody out of the play.
I think that's a poor decision on their part. They're making yards off tackle, and then with a yard for a first down, they try to go wide.
And the loss is all the way back to their own 45-yard line. So a loss of 7 on the play, and they're looking at fourth down and 9. And the punter will come on to punt it away. Weevils will send Gamage back deep again for UAM. A good snap. Gets off a better punt. High, wobbly kick. They're going to move away from it, let it bounce. It hits at the 20, rolls inside the 15. Going to go out of bounds, down around the 11-yard, make it the 12-yard line. And that's where the Weevils will start their second possession here in the third quarter. 7:57 to play in the third. It's 32-0. UAM has the lead over the Bulldogs of Southwest Oklahoma State.
Nice play on on the third down to force them to punt. They had a little drive going, but then UAM bowed their neck a little and forced them into a punt. So
you'll leave your starters out there probably the rest of this third quarter.
And about then, one more score.
Yeah. And then
let some other folks have a little shot at it.
Demayan Brown, the quarterback. Hayden Thomas is back in at the running back spot for the Boll Weevils. From their own 12, Demayan. Now they blow it dead. We'll see what if it's either delay a game or a procedure call against the Weevils, I think. I think the play clock had gone out. No flag. We're going to wave it off. Okay.
I think he lost his flag.
Okay.
I don't think he threw it.
All right, here we go. First and 10 for the Weevils from their own 12. Again, Brown, your quarterback, Demalia, has gone all the way so far tonight for UAM. Gets the snap, going to hand it off. Hayden Thomas. Thomas hitting the backfield. He's going to lose a couple of yards. Yeah, say one thing. This Bulldog defense hadn't given up.
No.
They're still playing hard.
Got some big guys across the front.
The loss of two on the play. It'll be second down and 12 now. Weevils go with a double tight end. Here to this side, to the near side, the short side of the field, into the boundary. Brown wanting to throw. Forced out of the pocket, running to his right, looking down the field, throws it away. Threw it at the feet of his intended receiver.
I think he should have kept running that time.
They bring up third down and 12 now for the Boll Weevils. Ball spotted at their own 11-yard line. Thomas stays in at the running back. Twin receivers, Nick Howard and Arlie Lee, come wide left. Brown, straight drop. They bring the blitz, steps up, fires over the middle, going to be incomplete. Intended for cross. He just running a crossing pattern, drag pattern across the middle of the field. He was open, but again, sometimes Demayan puts too much on that short pass.
Exactly.
So the Weevils are going to be forced to punt it away. The incomplete pass does stop the clock with 7:17 left to play here in the third. UAM up 32-0. Incomplete control.
First time they've had to punt from this kind of field position.
Yeah. About 5 yards deep, Grisotti will stand to get the snap. He gets a good snap and another beautiful kick. It turns over. It'll be caught by Henderson, and he's hit immediately. Down on the special teams for the Boll Weevils, making the hit number 39. And that is Mike Lucen, a redshirt freshman out of Palm Beach, Florida. Made the hit on him, but up at the 43-yard line.
He smoked him pretty good.
32-yard punt, no return. For the first time tonight, I think Southwest will start on the UAM side of the 50-yard line.
Exactly.
Pfeiffer, your quarterback. Heist, the lone setback. Wanting to throw. Play action. Has a man wide open. Complete at the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown. Bulldogs and a breakdown in the secondary.
Cornerback bit on the inside fake to the running back.
And the Bulldogs are on the board. With 7:02 to play here in the third quarter, UAM still leads 32-6. And now,
swinging gate.
Yeah, there we go. Some confusion on the Southwest side, too. I'm not sure they got 11 out there. Maybe they do. As they'll swing the gate over to on the extra point. They got everybody shifted. The kicker is set. Snaps down. The kick is on its way, and it is good. 32-7. Southwest gets on the board here in the third quarter. 7:02 left to play in the third period. We'll be back with more UAM football right after this timeout.
with 7 minutes to play in the third quarter. Southwestern is on the board with 7 points, and your UAM Blue Weevils 32.
Back here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, the Bulldogs get on the board. We gave them the short field to work with. They had 42 yards to go following the punt. The UAM had a punt from their own end zone.
They took advantage of that short field, too.
And they get on the board here. 32-7 our score here with 7:02 left to go in the third quarter. Still a lot of football to go.
They might be cooking up an onside kick here, maybe. I know it's a lot of time left, and it would be bad if they didn't get it, but they got a little momentum going here. They might.
Harley Lee will go back deep for the Weevils, along with Giovanni Gibson. Lee had a good return his last time.
Coach Jackson is hollering at him. He seems to think they might try to kick it short.
They're going to kick it deep.
No, I kicked it deep.
Harley Lee will field it at the 5. Back up to the 10, the 15, waiting for his play to develop. Breaks through at the 30, out to the 40. One man left to beat, and could it be inside the 40 and finally brought down at the 35-yard line.
Excellent return.
Harley, waited for his blocks to get set up.
That's the second time they've got to one spot, and then it kind of opened up good, and he hit through that hole really well.
So the Weevils will have it out at the 34-yard line of the Bulldogs. And you have to think, if they had any momentum coming back after that touchdown score.
We just ended it right there. I was just fixing to say that's a good way to return after they score the touchdown. That's a good way to get them back on their heels again.
32-7 our score. Weevils on top. First and 10. Bowl Weevils at the 34-yard line of Swazoo. Brown out of the shotgun. Brown, play action, wanting to throw. Brown looking down the middle for Cross. He cuts back inside. Touchdown, Bowl Weevil. One play, 34 yards. Isaiah Cross with the catch.
That catch hard to deal with.
Yeah. UAM put 38 points on the board. Last week they put 49 points on the board. And I know you start looking and comparing. Ouachita traveled and played this same team in Weatherford last week. And I think the score was 28-14.
Really?
I think I have to go back and check that score, but it wasn't this lopsided. Snaps down. The kick's on its way as Grisotti
said he missed it.
He missed it. Wide right. 38-7. The Weevils still lead here with 6:42 to play in the third quarter. And a ball game that's had a lot of passes and a lot of stoppage of the clock. And I don't know. We're close to, 3 hours? Huh? No, 2 hours.
Just 2 hours.
Just 2 hours. Seems like three. Yeah. We'll take a break. We'll be back in a moment. Thank you. Weevils will kick it off. Henderson will field it at the 10, returns it up over the 20, up to the 25, gets upended there, and almost a little extracurricular activities going on the field. Weevils lead at 38-7 at this point, though. And Sam, you know, as we talked about, Southwest had the short field to work with. They scored a touchdown, had some momentum, but then Arlie Lee took all the wind out of themselves with a great kickoff return. It set up the Weevils' next score.
And the Bulldogs had a couple of pretty good kickoff returns themselves. Good coverage by the Weevils there.
Pfeiffer bobbles the snap, pulls it down. He'll have to eat it himself. He'll carry it back up to about a yard gain on the play. Ball was on the 22. He'll get it out to the 23. So we'll call it second down and 9. Heist stays in as the lone running back. He'll line up on the left side. Fife wanting to throw again. Fife looking. Throwing short, underneath, complete, up to the 28. Got to be hit and ran down there. And, boy, he got clobbered. That was Jack Pierce.
Put a pretty good stroke on him.
Yeah, he paid for it, didn't he? He held on to the football. A gain of 4 on the play. It'll be third down and 5. Pfeiffer again out of the shotgun. On third and 5. Play action. Throws picked. Intercepted and returned. Back to the 30, the 20, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Ball Weevils. A pick 6 for the Weevils. With 5:31 left to go. I'm trying to see who came up with that interception.
I can't tell the number.
A pick 6 with a 35-yard return. And I still couldn't catch the number.
Is that him right in the middle of the...
I think so. But the Weevils get a pick 6 and go up 44-7. And here we go again with the extra point coming. Duhon going to attempt the extra point here. Snaps down, the kick's on its way, and this one is good. Weevils blow it open, 45-7 now with 5:31 left to go. 20 points scored here in the third quarter alone. We'll take a break. We're back with more in just a moment. Weevils lead. They kick it off. Henderson will field it at the 10, up over the 15, the 20, and boy, gets upended out near the 27-yard line. And that's where the Bulldogs are going to start, first and 10, up at their own 27.5, almost the 28-yard line. But anytime your defense can put points on the board,
exactly,
boy, things are going good.
Exactly.
Weevils 45-7 over Southwest Oklahoma. We still got 5:23 to play here in the third quarter.
We might need to lobby for the sportsmanship rule.
On first and 10, Pfeiffer out of the shotgun, wanting to throw, looking, wanting to go deep down the left sideline. The defender is there and going to bat it away at the last second.
Nice play.
Greg Hooks. And I really wish we could have picked out the number
of who had
the pick 6.
Exactly.
Because it's over there. That's where Hooks has been playing defensive corner. But I really think it was one of the linebackers that came up and made the play. All right, second down and 10. Piper, straight drop, quarterback draw now. He'll turn it up the field. It's going to be a short gain of a couple. And then the defense collapses on him. First one to get there is Robert Iverson, the linebacker.
He's feeling that one a little bit. He's got a few cobwebs, looks like. He's like, where'd that truck come from?
Got his hands on his hips, didn't
exactly
he?
Like, oh, man.
Third down and a long six now for the Bulldogs. Piper, straight drop, throws, quick pass, going to be incomplete behind his intended receiver. Closest defender there for the Weevils was Jaden McCary.
Secondary is really working good. There's not much room for the quarterback to try to get it in there. So
fourth down and six. Another punting situation for the Bulldogs. Gamage will go back deep again for the Weevils. He'll stand at his own 30. Hadn't had an opportunity to return a punt tonight. They've been kicking it away from him or short, and he's even having to let it hit the ground. As the punter, Dayton Thrower, gets a snap. Nice high spiraling kick. Gamage is going to field this one and try to return it. He's up to the 30. Gets to the outside, 35, 40, 45, and finally run out of bounds around the 47-yard line. Nice return there following the punt.
Finally was able to catch it in the air.
And the Weevils will start out beyond their own 45-yard line. How about they're going to start in Bulldog territory at the 48-yard line?
Nice return.
So once again, another short field position to work with. And I think we're going to see some new faces.
Exactly. I was just fixing to say that. Looks like we for sure have a new quarterback.
Buddy Taylor, 5'11", redshirt freshman out of River Ridge, Louisiana. See his first action as a Boll Weevil.
New receivers. Looks like may even be some new linemen maybe.
Yeah. Well-deserved break, though, for the starters.
Exactly.
Hey, you got 45-7, and now a timeout called on the field here with 4:24 to play in the third quarter. A timeout taken on the field. We'll take it with them and be back with more UAM football after this timeout.
Looks like with
Seven. The Weevils have the lead here in the third quarter. 4:24 left to play. Well, you go back and look. 20 points scored here in the second half. You got seven out of your defense or six out of your defense on a pick six. And really, tonight against Southwest, the Weevils have been playing in all phases of the game.
Exactly. Their punter's done a good job. Hadn't cost them field position, and I'm really impressed with the defense. They're playing hard. And they're only rushing four. They're not doing much, if any, blitzing. And kind of hard for their receivers to find a spot where they're open.
They took the timeout. And I think they're going to respot the football back where I said it should have been, back at the 47.
I think that's what they're doing.
Yeah.
You were right. It's the 48. They were just on the wrong side of the 50. Or they were wrong on the wrong side of the 50.
But the Weevil still was short field to work with from their own 48-yard line. Buddy Taylor is a quarterback now, the redshirt freshman out of River Ridge, Louisiana. And we got a lot of pretty fresh jerseys out there, it looks like.
Oh, my gosh.
The Cedric Smith in at wide receiver. He's one of the starters. Now what's the stoppage of play? Waiting on the head umpire to get back in five, back in position. All right, here we go. Finally, on first and 10. Handoff goes, I think that's Furman, Gary Furman. He'll get across midfield to the 49, a gain of 3 on the play before he gets stood up there. That's Christian Smith make it. Christian Smith, the ball carrier. He and Furman are built a lot alike.
Exactly.
One wears 20 and one wears 26. Gain of 3, second down and 7. Handoff again, Christian Smith. This time he hit at the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. He'll be driven backwards. Right now, UAM just wants the clock to run. It's going to be 3:42 left to play here in the third. Weevils on top, 45-7. Caleb Jacobs will split wide to the right. We'll see what Taylor can do at quarterback. He's wanting to throw. Steps up, going to be in trouble, going to get sacked. Taylor goes down for the sack. And it'll bring up a fourth down. The loss is going to be back to about the original line of scrimmage, back at the 48. So it'll be fourth down and 10. And we'll send the punting unit on. But the Weevils lead 45-7. And this game has been, I mean, since the get-go. The first 6 minutes of the game, UAM had scored 19 points. And they've never looked back since that juncture of the game.
That third quarter was almost a carbon copy of the first one.
Yeah. End-over-end kick this time by Grisotti. It'll take a Weevil bounce. It hits at the 25, goes inside the 20, down to about the 17-yard line. How many times tonight, though, has Southwest Oklahoma State started inside their own 20?
Exactly.
And it's been the special teams, the punting unit.
Nice punter. Nice punter. He's done a good job the whole night.
They'll spot it down at the 16-yard line. But we may have a new quarterback for Southwest, Elijah Reed. Looks like number 12. Am I right on that?
I think so.
On first down, wanting to throw, go quick hook pattern out over the 20, out to the 25. A flag's going to come in late after the play was blown dead. A nice gain on the play of about 9 yards. See what the flag's all about. Personal foul against face mask against the Weevils. Penalties have not been that big tonight, though,
no,
for either team.
Especially any kind of like procedure. There hadn't been any of that hardly at all.
Yeah. They'll add that on to the end of the run. They'll mark it out to the 40-yard line. First and 10 Bulldogs from their own 40. Wanting to throw, going deep down the right side, going to overthrow and out of bounds. His intended receiver. Defending on the play for UAM, that's going to be Timothy Gordon, sophomore out of Nashville, Tennessee. He was stride for stride with the receiver.
That's the starter quarterback back in.
Back in. Number 16, Pfeiffer back in.
No, that's 17, my bad. Sorry.
All right, 17 is Calvin Cloud.
He's a sophomore, I think.
Number 17,
throws an incomplete pass.
Incomplete. Brings up third down.
Yeah, it'll be third down and 10 from their own 40-yard line. Does stop the clock, though, the incomplete pass with 2:25 to go here in the quarter. Cloud, the quarterback. Straight drop, pumps, now wants to go deep, and again overthrows his intended receiver. That is Taylor Tosh. Tosh is going to be tired after running those fly patterns down the field and getting overthrown.
Looks like they may go for it here.
Well, it's fourth down and 10 from their own 40-yard line.
They really don't have anything to lose.
Down 45-7, our score, UAM on top. And now they're going to send the punting unit on.
Sided against it.
Gamage will go back deep again for the Boll Weevils. Had a nice return his last time up. He'll stand about his own 25-yard line to wait the snap. Now whistles blow as a snap.
Flag on the play.
And let's see what the flag's about.
That's got to be motion.
Yes. We still got 2:17 to play here in the third quarter. Weevils on top, 45-7.
Offsides.
Offsides against the defense.
Hmm.
Somebody lined up in the neutral zone.
He's going to get a talk to by the coach, maybe.
So that'll make it 4th and 5. They're still going to stay in the punting formation. And Gamage again held back up and stand at his own 20 to await the snap. He gets the snap, they kick it away from him. It's going to be a short kick, hits it to 35, bounds out of bounds, down around the 30-yard line. Look at the 31, the 32-yard line. That's where the Weevils will have it, 1st and 10. From their own 32 here.
They may need to have a little. When they get back to Oklahoma, they may need to have a little punting practice tomorrow. Our punters have had a rough go of it.
1st and 10, Weevils from their own 32-yard line. Backup quarterback's in, Buddy Taylor. Say backup. We need to say cleanup quarterback.
There you go.
He's hoping to clean this thing up.
Next up.
Taylor takes the snap, wanting to throw, looking, fires to the far sideline. It's caught and falling down immediately out at the 38-yard line. Try to catch who that is on the reception. Black uniforms, green numerals.
Make it hard to see those numbers.
Is that 85?
I think so. Is that Gamage?
Gamage. Mm-hmm. Made the catch. It's good for 6 yards. It'll be 2nd down and 4. So on 2nd and 4, Taylor again out of the gun. Leaves it with his back up the middle. Carries across the 40. The pile pushing forward across the 45 and all the way out to the 48-yard line.
Coach Qualls is calling the basic stuff now. That's letting the clock run and gaining yards at the same time.
As a ball carrier that time for the Weevils. And that was Gary Furman. His offensive line got behind him and pushed him 5 yards down the field. 1st and 10, Boll Weevils at their own 48. 45-7. UAM leads it. Southwest only score came here in the third quarter. All right, Taylor again out of the shotgun. Looks over the defense, wanting to throw. Runs to his right. A little jump pass complete. Caleb Jacobs down at the 40-yard line of the Bulldogs. It's going to be good for 13 yards and a first down.
Nice pass.
You look at Buddy Taylor. He's a redshirt freshman from River Ridge, Louisiana. John Curtis Christian School there in Louisiana.
He made a nice throw there.
Ball spotted at the 40-yard line of Southwest Oklahoma State. Clock continues to run. We're down to 15 seconds, and UAM's going to let the time expire. We'll be headed toward the fourth quarter.
Coach Qualls gave him the stop sign. Just let her go. Just let her run.
The play clock and the game clock are almost exactly alike. Yeah. There we go. At the end of the third quarter, the Weevils will head into the final 15 minutes of football with a 38-point lead. It's 45-7. And we'll be back with the final fourth quarter action for you in just a moment.
Will attempt to field goal for a chance to win a $100 gift certificate from the UAM Bank Bookstore, presented by SGA and the Student Activities Board. Fans, let's make some noise. Let Braylon hear you.
Yeah.
Make it loud, make it loud. Just a little bit short. Thank you, Brandon Miller. For attempting today's field goal, sponsored by the SGA and the Student Activities Board.
Weevils have the lead. We get set to start the fourth quarter. First and 10, UAM from the Bulldog, 40-yard line. Taylor, your quarterback, wanting to throw again. Fires this one and short hops it out to Cedric Smith. Under threw him.
A little short hop there.
Long pass, though. He's on the right hash bar and throwing all the way to the far sideline.
His receiver didn't help him out much trying to come back for it, but it's good for him to get the play. So.
Yep. Second down and 10 now for the Boll Weevils. As Taylor looks over the defense, he'll bring the blitz up the middle. He unloads a wide receiver screen, complete to Cedric. Cedric cuts it up the sideline to the 35. The 30 finally going to be pushed out of bounds. Down at the 29-yard line.
That's been a good play several times during the game. Their receiver's getting outside. Pretty nice block by the slot receiver.
So it'll be second down. He get the first down, didn't he? Yes, first down. Move the chains inside the 30 at the 29-yard line. First and 10, Boll Weevils. Ball will be on the left hash mark. Weevils moving from left to right here in the fourth quarter. From north to south. Going to hand it. Nope. Taylor keeps it himself. Quarterback inside the 25 to the 20. Still on his feet and going to be bumped out of bounds at the 18-yard line.
Nice read and run.
He's got the RPO, the run-pass option. He's got the option to pull it out of the back's belly, and he did.
He's pretty shifty, too.
He's good for another first down. Picked up 12. As they'll mark it at the 18-yard line. First and 10, Boll Weevils. And they're doing it with the second-string offense out there. On first and 10. Taylor, this time he leaves it up the middle to the 15, to the 10, upended down at the 10-yard line. As that is going to be Tristan Smith. He's a junior.
Oh, me.
Now a penalty against the Weevils.
Holding. Yes.
So that'll nullify that run. And they'll spot the football where it'll be back outside the 25, out at the 28-yard line. We need to get down to just inside the 10 for our first down. So it's going to be first and 20. Taylor calling for the snap. Under pressure now as he rolls to his left, looking down the field, throws it short and out of bounds over there on the far sideline. This time the Bulldogs brought some pressure, but Taylor recognized it, was able to avoid it.
I thought he was going to run once he first got out of the first defender, but hard to roll to your left and throw it back right.
Yeah, on your across your body.
Yes.
Second down and 20 now for the Weevils. Twin receivers go to either side. 45-7 our score. Weevils with the lead in the football. Taylor again wanting to throw. Forced out of the pocket. Running to his right. Looking down the field. Has a man open in the end zone. It's going to be caught. That's Gamage. Gamage with a running touchdown to start the football game. And here in the fourth quarter, catches a touchdown pass there.
28 yards.
12:36 to play in the fourth quarter, and the Weevils are up 51-7.
The fat lady is starting to hum.
The Weevils are going to send in, let's see, Duhon again. Yep, Duhon will attempt the extra point. Out of the hold of Caleb Jacobs. Gets the snap down. The kick's on its way, and it is good. 52-7. The Weevils all over Southwest Oklahoma State here at home. We'll take a break. We'll be back in just a moment.
Just kicking it.
Fans, the UAM Sports Association is the exclusive private fundraising arm of UAM Athletics. Its mission is to raise private funds to support 300 volleyball and football student athletes in competition on and off the field. Annual membership starts at $50. Visit UAMSports.com to learn more about the UAM Sports Association, become a member, and make an investment in UAM Athletics today.
Seven, the Weevils on top of Southwest Oklahoma State. 12:36 to play here in the ball game, and you know you got to be impressed. Some of these younger players getting to play and moving it down the field. That was a nice pass,
exactly,
from Buddy Taylor to
Gamage.
Gamage
had a nice drive. I mean, used up some clock. Didn't get any. Well, got one holding penalty, but they made up for that. So. It's good to see them all get to play.
Yeah.
They've been practicing as long as the big dogs, so that'll make them feel better about going to practice next week. I got to play. Maybe I'll get to play next week. So nice little drive.
52-7. Again, the Weevils have the lead. They'll get set to kick it off. Duhon handling the kickoffs for the Weevils. Henderson back on one side. This one will go to Henderson as he's going to let it hit the ground and go into the end zone for an automatic touchback. And they'll start first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. This is where the Bulldogs will have it. But there's a flag all the way back up here. That may be a offsides on the kickoff. Let's see if we can get it called. Yep, offsides on the kicking team.
I thought that was a penalty that deserved not only a flag but a whistle to stop it immediately on the offsides, keep them from running, having to run all the way down the field.
Well, instead of starting at the 25, they'll award them 5 yards here.
Well, that's, yeah, exactly.
And they'll start at the 30.
I mean,
first and 10 for the Bulldogs from the 30-yard line. Calvin Cloud, our third quarterback of record here tonight for the Bulldogs. He hands it off and into the backfield, swarmed and dropped for a loss. Going to be the running back, Keon Talbert. Might be the some of the starting four. We see them rotate about 8 or 9 guys end up on the defensive line. But
yeah,
this is still some of the same starters out there on that defensive front four for the Bull Weevils. Cloud out of the shotgun on second down and 12. Throws over the middle. Got a man wide open at the 30. Up to the 35. Going to be hit from behind and brought down at the 38-yard line. That was a tight end dragging across the field.
They've thrown that route several times throughout the game.
And the linebacker hadn't been anywhere close.
No. They hadn't figured that one out yet.
Gain of 9 on the play. Third down and 1. Gain of 12, actually. For the third and 1. Out of the shotgun. Cloud for the Bulldogs. Hands it off right side. He's hit behind the line of scrimmage and not going anywhere. He'll lose a couple of yards, actually. Getting up off the bottom of the pile. Big number 90 for the Bull Weevils. That is Johnny Taylor.
He has stopped short of the first down. He's up.
So, loss of 1. It'll be third down and 2.
Fourth down. You're right. Fourth down and two for the Bulldogs.
Weevils lead at 52-7. As we go under 11 minutes left to play, and they're going to send the punting unit on once again.
They're about to wave the white flag.
As their punter will come on, it's thrower again. Is Gamage back deep? Yep. It's a good snap. Ah, wobbly kick. Gamage is going to let it hit the ground. It will hit and be touched at the 21-yard line as it bounced right into a Bulldog player who's going down on the special teams. So the Weevils will have it start first and 10 at their own 21-yard line. Here with 10:27 left to play in the football game, and the Weevils leading 52-7. It was 25-0 at the half. If you joined us late, the Weevils scored the first 19 points in the first 6 minutes of the first quarter. And then both teams were scoreless until 36 seconds to go in the half, where the Weevils punched one in, made it 25-0 at halftime. The Bulldogs' only score came there in the third quarter, and then since then the Weevils have scored 14 unanswered since they scored. There's a complete pass from Taylor out over the 30 to the 32-yard line. And
Jordan Mansfield.
Mansfield, yeah, number 19. He's a sophomore out of Bastrop, Louisiana, making the catch. Move the chains, another first down.
Nice throw.
Out to the 31-yard line. First and 10. Again, Taylor, your quarterback, Buddy Taylor, wants to throw again. This was picked, and a pick six coming. Oh, wow. Stepped right in front of the intended receiver. That's what you want these younger players to get time for, to learn.
Waiting on that screen that time.
And a pick six by Southwest Oklahoma. Short return, what, 30 yards?
Yes. Yeah, he was waiting on that one.
So the Bulldogs will use the old swinging door again. No, they're going to light up traditionally, it looks like, and kick this one. With 9:39 to play in the ball game, it's now 52-13. Snaps down, it kicks on its way, and it is good. 52-14. The Weevils still lead. At least that defensive back will have something good to talk about on the bus ride home tonight. We got a timeout on the field. 52-14, our score. Weevils lead it. We're back in a moment. The Weevils still lead, even after the Bulldogs get that pick six here in the fourth quarter with 9:39 remaining. But again, you get these younger players in, and you know, you hope that the quarterback there, Robert Buddy Taylor, he's going to learn that he can't telegraph that
can't
pass.
Just look out there all the way. It looks like Coach Jackson is getting together a reserve kickoff return team, too.
You know, at this point, you don't want anyone to get hurt, and kickoff teams, specialty teams, are places where more injuries seem to happen. So you want to make sure that you don't get anybody hurt. All right. You got some sure-handed folks up front thinking that they might want to try an onside kick.
as their kicker will tee it up and set it up to go. That is Brandon McCary. He's going to kick it deep. This one's going to be fielded at the 15, up to the 20. The 25 makes one man miss, out over the 30. The 35 finally upended. The ball came loose, but I believe they're going to blow it dead. As on the return for the Weevils, that was Giovanni Gibson.
Nice return.
Mark it out at the 36-yard line. Weevils will have it first and 10. Our center right now is Liam Brace. I'm trying to run down some of the other players out there for you. Quarterback Buddy Taylor. They'll put him right back in after he threw that pick six and let him kind of grow up. They're going to hand it off left side. That is going to be Gary Furman on the carry. He'll gain about a yard. We'll call it second down and 9. The Cedric Smith splits wide to the right. One receiver goes wide left. Furman stays in at the running back spot. We go under 9 minutes left to play in the game. Weevil still on top, 52-14. Play action. One to throw. Fires into the sideline. It's caught out over the 40. Up the field, up to the 45-yard line. Going to be about a yard shy of a first down, I believe. We'll see where they mark this forward progress. He stepped out of bounds way back at the 42.
Two.
Yeah. So we have a third down and 4. Third and 4 for the Weevils from their own 42-yard line. Ball on the left hash mark. Weevils moving from left to right here in this fourth quarter. Handoff, Furman. Furman trying to get to that first down marker. Going to get it out to the 45-yard line. Going to be a yard shy of the first down.
They might still go for it.
So we go under 8 minutes left to play. Main thing you want to think you would want to keep the clock running. 52-14, Weevils lead it.
Looks like he's keeping the offense out there.
Taylor will back up in the shotgun. Furman alone set back. Taylor's going to keep it himself. Breaks it to the outside, running for the flag, and he's got the first down. Had the first down marker in sight, knew just where he needed to get to.
He's got a nice little second gear there he can get in.
Pretty quick. Move the chains, gotta keep the drive alive. Another first down for the Weevils. They'll spot it up at the 47-yard line. First and 10, Bull Weevils. Should go under 7 minutes when we snap this football. Play clock at 18, game clock at 7:09. We'll spend two receivers wide right, one wide left. Furman gets the handoff straight ahead. Furman up near the 49-yard line. Be stopped shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. His helmet came off, so he'll have to come out of the ball game. Checking back in for him is going to be Tristan Smith. A 1 yard gain, second down and 9. For the Bull Weevils, they mark it at the 48. Tight end set to the short side of the field. Going to hand it off. That's Tristan Smith straight ahead. He's across the midfield, the 45, the 40, all the way down to the 34-yard line. Boy, that's a quick hitter right up the middle.
Nice little opening there, and he was through it before they looked around good.
Tristan Smith.
And it's another clock runner.
Yeah, keeps
clock the clock mover.
Yeah, clock continues to run. Under 6 minutes now left to play here in the fourth quarter. Weevils up 52-14. Been all Weevils here tonight at home in the home opener.
Coach Qualls is waiting a long time before he gives him the call, too, to let the play clock keep running.
Buddy Taylor, the quarterback, out of the shotgun. Smith stays in at running back. Same play, they hand it off again, left side. Smith breaks the tackle at the 30 to the 25, the 20, 15, lowers his shoulder at the 10 and going to be pushed out of bounds. Inside the 5-yard line, it looks like.
Tristan Smith on a nice run there. You know, some of these players, which he has played in the first half, but they get to play this scrap up and clean up tough. Hey, they want to show the coaches.
Exactly, that they can do it.
They can do it.
Yeah.
And that was a good run by Tristan Smith. First and goal to go. Ball spotted at the 3-yard line. Play clock down to 18. Coach Qualls finally going to call the play in here from the sideline. Smith stays in at the running back. Taylor, your quarterback. Play clock down to 3. Take the snap. Hand off left side. Tristan Smith into the end zone. Touchdown. Tristan Smith. We get his name in the record books here tonight.
Another nice drive led by Buddy.
58-14. So the Weevils, you know, they're going to have two games in their belt. They're going to be averaging over 50 points a ball game.
That'll give the Bison a little bit of something to think about.
Duhon on to attempt the extra point out of the hold of Jacobs. High snap. Jacobs gets it down. The kick is low and no good. 58-14, our score. The Weevils on top with 4:26 to play here in the fourth quarter. We'll be back with more from Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium when we return in just a moment. The Weevils with the lead have been putting it on all night long on the Bulldogs. They'll kick it off. This will be fielded by Henderson at the 5. Up to the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Going to be up to near midfield and finally brought down at the 49-yard line. Duhon, the kicker, who's the last man to catch him, was the one that brought him down.
I was just fixing to say the kicker didn't have any option on that. He either ran into him and he stopped him, or it was a touchdown.
A nice return by the Bulldogs here late in the ball game, as they'll have it first and 10 at their own 49-yard line. Again, it was 25-0 at halftime. Weevils were on top. And Weevils went on and, well, we put 33 on the board here in the second half. All right, Cloud gets the snap, hands it off to his back. He's across midfield at the 40, to the 35, 30, the 20, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Chris Trufant with the touchdown run of 51 yards.
51 yards. He pretty much, when he got to the line of scrimmage, it was pretty much over. He got a nice block out here on the corner by his wideout, and after that it was
pretty much green grass.
How much grass could he cover?
Wow, makes it 58-20. 78 points already scored in this ball game. Yep, that's a lot.
Like a basketball score almost.
We still got 3:57 left to play, just under 4 minutes left to play. As the kicker's on to attempt the extra point, McCrary. They get the snap down, the kick's up, and it is good.
It's good height on it. It's not much.
58-21. Weevils have the lead. We'll take the break and be back with the final 4 minutes of football, maybe when we return in a moment. 58-21. Weevils still have the lead as the Bulldogs will kick this one off. Short, high kick, hits the ground, finally going to be picked up and returned back at the 15, 20, 25, 30. Got some room, tripped up out over the 35-yard line. There's another nice return, though, by the Bull Weevils.
He thought he was fixing to take it to the house. That one guy just barely tripped him up.
That's Javon Gibson. Javonnie Gibson with the return.
He thought he was fixing to go about 90.
There's a flag back at the 15-yard line. It'll be against the Weevils, so we'll bring it back. Weevils are going to start deep in their own territory with 3:43 remaining in the game. Again, Weevils have dominated this ball game all night long. I mean, you go back and look, they had double the
yardage in the first half.
At half, 222 to 113.
You know they may have tripled them in this half.
It's 58-21. Weevils have scored 33 points here in the second half. And you look and say, well, Southwest scored 21. They had a pick six, but everything's come late in the third quarter and two touchdowns here in the fourth quarter.
Mm-hmm. And in between, that's when the Weevils have just done pretty much what they wanted to.
All right. We still have Buddy Taylor in as the quarterback. Yep, Buddy Taylor's the quarterback. Try to catch and see who the running back is now for the Weevils. Had Tristan Smith in last time. It's a snap, handoff over the left tackle, and not much there. Maybe a yard is all it is for the Weevil running back. Main thing's going to eat up some clock.
Exactly.
For the Bull Weevils, let's see. Running back is Furman, Gary Furman, number 26. No gain on that last play. It'll be second down and 10. The crowd's really stuck around for this ball game.
I was just looking. Oh, there's a lot of people still here.
Even in a blowout like this. Mm-hmm. But it's parent and family day here on the
campus.
There
should be some folks here.
Yeah.
That's good for UAM.
Second down, 10. Wanting to throw the football. He throws over the middle. Going to be incomplete.
Man, he threw a good ball there. I thought the receiver was going to get to that. That was a nice shot there by Buddy.
My Buddy Taylor. Clock stops with 2:43 to go with the incomplete pass. It'll be third down and 10 now for the Bull Weevils. As they're looking into Coach Qualls, waiting for him to call a play in. Game clock was not running, so he could have hurried up on that one a little bit. All right, here we go. On third and 10, handoff, Furman. Furman's got some room. Out over the 15, 20, 25. Got to be upended out near the 29-yard line. That'll move the chains, and that'll seal the deal for the Weevils.
Nice hole by the offensive lineman that time. He didn't come in contact with anybody for about 7 yards.
They'll move the chains all the way out to the 29-yard line. First and 10, Bull Weevils. Where they'll have it. And, you know, we've got to run about three more plays. 2:13 to play here, unless we throw the football.
If we can hit that quick hitter like that another time or two, we'll have to throw it.
First and 10.
These backup kids have done a good job. They've looked pretty good.
They've been going up against the number ones all season practice.
Exactly.
Hand off again. Furman, left side. Furman across the 30. He'll get about four on the play. Going to knock him down about the 33-yard line. Main thing is he stays in bounds. Clock continues to run. Second down and 6 now for the Weevils. Down to a minute 35 left to play.
Hayden, Tristan Smith is back in now.
That running back?
Yes.
He'll line up in the pistol formation behind Taylor, Buddy Taylor, the quarterback. Should be right at a minute left to go when we snap this football. Weevils leading 58-21. Handed off to Tristan Smith. Picks his way through the line. He's across the 35, out over the 40. He'll have the first down, and that's going to do it.
as they'll move the chains one final time. Weevils can let the play clock run down, snap it one more time, then they won't have to snap it again.
And the Dogs bus driver can go warm it up. Let her run for a while. Get the air conditioner running.
First and 10. Ball spotted at their own 40-yard line. Weevils lead at 58-21. They go into victory formation here. Taylor will go underneath center. Smith is back about 8 yards off the ball. He'll take the knee, and that's going to be your ball game. Our final score here tonight from Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. The Bowl Eagles get the win. They go to 2-0 on the season. Southwest will go to 0-2. And a big showdown coming next week here early in the conference season against Harding University.
That'll be a tough one.
58-21, our final score. We'll take a break. We'll come back and wrap this one up for you in just a moment.
Almost doubled them.
Back here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, the Weevils win it 58-21 over Southwest Oklahoma State. They're ringing the victory bell out there on the pond and celebrating, and probably here in the background, they're headed down. The team's headed over there to ring that victory bell as the crowd lets them know. Our final stats on the night, here we go. UAM 58-21. First downs, UAM with 26, Southwest with 10. Rushing yards, Southwest 28 for 103 yards. On the ground, the Weevils, 42 carries for 204 yards. That's got to be impressive for the Weevils, getting 200 yards rushing. Passing yards, 13 of 30 with one interception for Southwest, 147 yards to the air. The Weevils went 20 of 37, one interception, 285 yards. Weevils ran 79 plays, 489 yards on the night while holding Southwest to 58 plays and 250 yards. Defense played a really good ball game tonight.
Yes.
2 weeks in a row by almost 500 yards. We're going to be averaging 495 yards a game is what we're going to be averaging on offense in 2 weeks. Because last week we had an even 500.
That might give Harding a little something to think about.
You go back. We talked about special teams, punts. They punted the football and had some short punts. UAM had some good punts on the night. I was looking for the average. Here we go, punts. They had 10 punts, averaged 33 yards. We had 6 punts, averaged 38 yards. But, just
where we punted from was usually way better field position. They were back deep when they had to punt, and we were, you know, kind of in the middle of the field.
All right, let's look at individual numbers for you tonight. Gary Furman, 14 carries, 51 yards. Let's see. Demayan Brown had 6 carries for 52 yards. And then Hayden Thomas, 11 carries, 46 yards and a touchdown. And Tristan Smith, 5 carries, 38 yards and a touchdown on the night. Demayan Brown ends up going 14 of 27, no interceptions, 213 yards through the air, 4 TDs. The longest was a 50-yard strike there in the first half. Buddy Taylor, your backup quarterback, he went 6 of 10. They hope he learned a little bit by throwing that pick 6. But he ends up 6 of 10, 72 yards with a touchdown pass as well. Receiving, Isaiah Cross, 7 catches, 101 yards, 2 touchdowns. Giovanni Gibson, 4 catches, 70 yards, and a touchdown. Nick Howard, 3 catches, 36 yards, and a touchdown. And Christian Gamage, 2 catches and a touchdown, 34 yards on the night. All you can say is the Weevils dominated this game here tonight.
From start to finish. From the opening kickoff.
So we get to travel to Harding. And I need to look back and see who had that pick six for UAM. We never did find that out. I was going to look on this recap here. It is Gilliard. Interception return. Number 38 for the Weevils. It's his first name. Jalen. Jalen Gilliard had that pick six, and we could never catch his number. So congratulations to that young man on his pick six. Again, our final score, 58-21. The Weevils win it. They improved to 2-0 on the season. Head to Harding University next Saturday, 6 o'clock kickoff. We'll be there to bring you all the play-by-play. I hope you've enjoyed our broadcast here tonight. For Coach Sam Johnston, I'm Jimmy Sledge. And for Andrea Camden, our technical engineer back at the station, we'll say thanks for listening. Have a great rest of the weekend. We'll see you back next weekend with more UAM football.
Do they go ring the bell after every win? Okay.